It was a blockbuster weekend at the box office. So how did Daredevil star Ben Affleck celebrate Monday? By eating sushi in Beverly Hills.
Right.
Congratulations, 48 male. That's pretty good this week.
Okay. Did he just happen to be eating sushi? Or, I mean, does that really constitute a celebration? How did he celebrate? By wiping his ass after he took a crap.
Right, like we all do.
Right.
It's the party
How
meal,
is
right?
eating the sushi really a celebration? Wouldn't he probably be eating sushi anyway?
Yes, he would have.
They caught him eating sushi.
I don't think he needs to have a big movie to go out to sushi.
Right.
You know, just need the big pay increase.
Exactly. Well, now he can go eat sushi.
Right, I always wanted the salmon.
I would not have eaten sushi if we had done only $5 million.
It was a blockbuster weekend at the box office. So how did Daredevil star Ben Affleck celebrate Monday? By eating sushi in Beverly Hills.
Well, of course.
48 male. That's pretty good this week.
Not too shabby.
And after kindly signing autographs for fans, Ben stepped into his new Bentley and drove off into the busy L.A. street.
Keyshawn Johnson, you've just won the Super Bowl. How are you going to celebrate now? I'm going to go eat sushi! Right.
Well, every payday, Scott always says, well, today is sushi day.
That's right. Is it really?
But I'm not Ben Affleck.
Wow.
So I get it twice a month.
Yes. But he does drive a Bentley.
That's right. That's why I don't have a house.
Your $1,250 a month car payment.
Yeah. Well, I think it's very important that at this time in the program, we welcome in a very good friend of ours that we've grown to love in our own special way over the past, let's say, what, 5-6 months? Mm-hmm. If that. She is Constance the Bitchler spending time with us this morning. Yes.
Hello.
Looking very nice for 6 a.m.
Thank you.
Yes. I understand you're a little bit tired, huh?
Yeah.
Yes.
I'm real tired, yep.
Just get up?
No.
What time did you get up?
About 3 o'clock.
3 o'clock in the morning. Why did you get up at 3?
Go take kickboxing.
You took kickboxing already?
Yeah, sure did.
Why was a class that early?
Mm-hmm. What time was your class?
It's about 3:45.
You're lying. You have your own kickboxing class in your garage. Come on.
Okay.
It was a real...
Me and my kids go out there.
It was a real structured class of kickboxing at 4 in the morning.
Yes.
There was an instructor that wakes up to teach at 4 o'clock in the morning kickboxing class, and there are people. There are other people in there besides you?
Yeah, because other people start working at 6.
I understand. I know people start working at 6, but who would go to a kickboxing class at 4?
I don't know.
You
have to
work. You work at 6. You get up at 5. If you can
Men
stretch
get up
it.
At 5:30.
If you can stretch it, you get up at 5:30, 5:45.
A lot like today for me.
Yeah. I work at 6. My alarm goes off at 5.
Wow.
I shower last thing before I go to bed, so I don't have to shower in the morning. Make every second count. Even when my alarm goes off at 5, I hit snooze.
Oop, no teeth brush today.
Right. You got up at 3 to do a 4 o'clock kickboxing class.
Yeah, that's not every day.
How many people were in your class today?
About 12.
There were 12 idiots who could have been sleeping.
It's not an idiot.
It's an idiot. Could have been sleeping. And they
it
were
gets
doing...
your blood going. It gets you up.
Did you say you take your kids with you?
Sometimes, yeah.
Were they with you today?
Mm-hmm.
Doing what?
Sitting there doing their little tumbling.
Oh, jeez.
Yeah.
Thinking to themselves, Ma, can we go back to bed?
No.
Man, I don't get it. There's no time during the rest of the day that these 12 people couldn't do kickboxing? If kickboxing's so important, you can't do it at 7 p.m.? You can't do it sometime at lunch hour?
Apparently not.
It would serve your body a lot better to get extra sleep as opposed to waking up at 3 in the morning and doing kickboxing. You think you're doing your body good by doing kickboxing.
No, because I don't stay up really late. Go to bed early, wake up early.
But like she said, it's good. It gets you going for the day, and you're energized and ready to go.
Is
Listen
that
to
right?
her. She sounds so energized.
Yeah, by 11 a.m. By 11 a.m., your body's crashing.
This is true.
Right, nap time.
That's true.
So what time do your kids go to bed?
About 7, 7:30.
12:30.
Yeah. Some nights, yeah, but no.
7:30.
Mm-hmm.
They go to bed.
Yes.
How old are they now?
4 and 3.
4 and 3. Mm-hmm. And they were tumbling.
Yes.
At 5 a.m.
Against their will. They got thrown downstairs.
Right. Yeah.
Really. Wasn't any structure to it.
Okay, the daycare's not open. Let me just tumble you down the stairs. That should knock you out for an hour. Now mommy does her kickboxing. 4 a.m. till what? Till 5?
Yeah.
And the teacher doesn't, like, sit there cursing under his breath how much he hates his life or she hates her life?
It's a she, and no. She's
enjoys
more energized than anyone I've ever seen.
Well,
so.
4 a.m, she's energized and she's happy to be there.
Yeah.
She's genuinely happy to be there at
kickboxing. She's getting paid to be there.
Well, yes. Well,
it's got to cost more at that time of day, doesn't it?
You have to pay her more to be the 4 a.m. kickboxing teacher, right?
I don't know. I didn't really price the evening classes.
I don't get it. I don't know. So you know these people that are in your class?
Sometimes.
It's probably the same freaks every time, right?
More women than men, I should say that.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
You didn't just dream this, because I dream about working out all the time.
Sad.
Steven did a 4 o'clock kickboxing class this morning, too.
No.
Then Amy told him one more time, and he's going to sleep in the other room. I don't get it.
Well, good for you.
When you walk in 4 in the morning to the kickboxing class, does the teacher just welcome you by playing this?
The Bitchler. Starring The Bitchler.
Yes or no?
No.
Probably the kickboxler.
The kickboxler. Dayton, Ohio, good morning.
Good morning, T-Man.
How are you?
I'm getting really ticked off because I can't find a damn parking space.
Oh. Wait, she got up at 4 in the morning.
That's I get up at 5. I have to go to a boot camp aerobics class in the morning. So.
Boot camp aerobics.
Whoa.
Man, there's an aerobics for every just facet of life now, isn't there?
No. Well, I'm in the military, so.
Yes. Well, that would serve you well, then, I guess, to do the boot camp aerobics. I do the radio announcer aerobics.
Right.
I would rather do that.
Mm-hmm. Talk show host aerobics, let me tell you. No tumbling harder than that. So what can we do for you this morning, love?
Well, I was just calling basically to say that I was listening to our radio station here, and it's yesterday's show.
Yes.
And I swear, if my mom came to my defense every single time somebody started something with me, I have to get rid of my mother.
Well, the key is that you're 73, so that would be quite the feat, but... You're talking about Star, obviously. Every time Star gets on the radio, her mom feels the need to call to make sure the umbilical cord is very much intact and all that stuff. Is that what you're feeling?
Yeah, I mean, my God, give your kids some space. I have a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old, and they have more space than Star does.
Oh, geez. Well, as I said, the Constance-Star little feud was fun while it lasted. As far as I'm concerned, been there, done that. It's getting old.
It's very 2002.
Unless, of course, they're just going to throw down like never seen before. The verbal assaults are over.
Yes.
I think Constance is more mature than that.
Mm-hmm. I don't know about that.
Now, Constance, yes.
Every woman has their day where they're ready to rip somebody's throat out.
And the button that Star seems to find with Constance is calling her kids illegitimate.
Yeah.
But Constance's kids...
It doesn't matter. I don't think it really matters.
Well,
Who really gives a good crap? It's not Star's business.
Well, let me show you the difference. Constance had her kids while she was married. Correct or incorrect?
Correct.
Yeah, so that would be legitimate kids.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that sounds pretty legitimate.
Now, Terry Free, on the other hand, is not even here to defend herself, has illegitimate kids. So you see the difference there? You have illegitimate kids and legitimate kids. There's your clear difference.
So yes, but you know something? When you have kids, as long as you care for them, they're still legitimate.
But even though Constance's kids, and she knows how they were born, are legitimate, it burns Constance up. You can tell.
Sure
and Star knows when Star calls them illegitimate kids. She knows that's a hot button.
My question would have to be, is Star a legitimate kid?
Oh. Okay.
I mean, it doesn't really sound like her mom is...
Well, her mom and her dad have been married for over 20 years, but they haven't had sex for the past 17.
What is wrong with that?
I don't know. But they're very happy, apparently. So, to each his own. They have a lot of sushi.
They
celebrate
happy.
All the time.
I mean, what does her dad think about the fact that... I don't even want to know.
So, Dayton, Ohio loves Constance as far as this caller's concerned.
I mean, I wouldn't say I love Constance, but I mean,
you would if you found a parking space, because you don't love anything
no,
right
haven't,
now.
No, I haven't found a parking place. Trust me.
Well, that boot camp aerobics
here.
Can be very popular, let me tell you.
No, it's not boot camp aerobics. I'm trying to get into work.
Oh, and what do you do again? You work with the military?
Yes.
And any chance you're going to be sent away anytime soon, or you're staying here?
I am staying here.
Mm-hmm. What is your responsibilities with the military in Dayton, Ohio?
I wish it was parking.
Mm-hmm. You want to be a parking attendant. That's your ultimate goal.
Well, I would like to show people how to park.
I see. Okay.
But
very nice.
My responsibility is just a lot of typing.
So did Dayton get hit by the big storm or no?
Yes, we did. That's why
The mother of them all.
Yes, it was.
Blanketing the East Coast and many of our affiliates over there.
Yep.
That was the granddaddy of them all.
I don't know if it was the grand... It was pretty big. I mean, I shoveled quite a bit.
Mm-hmm. But I was talking about snow.
We shovel it every day.
Yes.
No, there's a lot of snow. I mean, it was. Yes. I mean, what's a lot of snow? I mean, 24 feet, 24 inches is a lot of snow.
And that's four penises, you and me. Now, wow. What is your name, love?
My name is Liz.
Oh, that's a nice fake name. Liz, okay. We'll be looking forward to your next call to us.
Okay.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
That's Liz in Dayton. May?
Yes.
Oh, jeez.
May.
May?
Yes.
Why are you calling?
I just want to know why.
May?
Mm-hmm.
You sat on hold all through the morning yesterday.
Yes. Like idiot.
Yes, because at the beginning of the show, I said, May, if you sit on hold all morning long, by the end of the show, I'll pick up the phone and tell you you're not coming down. And yet you sat on the phone all morning long.
I didn't hear that.
Don't you listen to the fine print?
May. Did say that,
yes.
May.
That's exactly what I said. Now, May, uh-huh. I could be honest with you. Terry Free, as everyone knows, is on her honeymoon, and we have various mm-hmm. listener hostesses coming down throughout the rest of the week. But we're pretty much all filled up. There's no openings for
okay.
May.
Okay, hey, man.
There'll be no May Day.
Okay, that's fine, T-Man.
Yes.
I just have a question for you.
Unless, of course, you sit on hold all morning long, then at 10 o'clock I'll pick up the phone and tell you you're not coming in.
That's okay. I feel better now.
What's your question?
From yesterday's show?
Yes.
Sounds like you are the one who's got married.
Yes.
Is that true?
I've said that. I said that yesterday morning.
Really?
And I said it before last, everyone thinks it's like it's a big secret. I had to give it a shot. T-Man has to procreate.
You didn't announce it.
I did. Did I not announce it yesterday
you
morning?
You said it yesterday.
You did, yeah.
May.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
See what happens when you're on hold all four hours? Everything comes one big blur.
I see. Okay.
Now listen. Because you sat on hold all morning
right.
yesterday.
I couldn't really get all the information
all right,
in,
no,
huh?
But no, we're done with that now. Because you sat on hold all 4 hours yesterday,
okay.
I think I can give May an hour in the studio as
really?
A fill-in guest host.
Oh.
She's going to have difficulty finding parking, though.
Yeah.
We'll make sure of that from noon to one.
She sticks with that boot camp aerobics. Yes, May, I have a slot for you open Saturday morning from 7 to 8 a.m. Are you available?
Even Constance didn't agree with you.
Mm. No.
Well, I wouldn't have waited on hold.
I know, Constance.
You shouldn't have waited on hold.
What day can you come down, May?
Are you serious?
No.
Oh.
But what day can you come down, just if I was serious?
Anytime. Uh-huh. I could be there with Constance. I won't fight with her.
Oh, jeez.
Oh.
Let's see. What day
okay.
you can come down anytime? Do we give May an hour?
Monday?
Terry Free's back Monday.
Oh.
Do we give May an hour, yes or no?
I think she's in.
Thanks, Hasha.
Oh,
but my vote means nothing, by the way. So.
Yeah. No, Mary. You are
May
married,
finds
yeah.
a way to slip into everything we do
true.
Lately. She came to the in-studio Christmas party, took pictures for 4 hours straight.
I have a picture of Constance.
She's got a cute little Asian Aww. Body. Doesn't, honestly, from the sound of her voice, she's not as old as she sounds. We expected May to be like middle age. She turned out to be like late 20s, right?
No.
What are
but
you?
That's okay.
What are you?
I'm in my 30s.
Ah, you Asians age so well, don't you?
Right.
Mm-hmm.
She filled
that's
up four autograph
Asian,
books.
Right?
Ah, I don't know what I meant. Anyhow.
Oh. Wasn't there.
Right. She's not Asian. But anyhow, she's half. Well, Pacific Island. Anyway. Is half Filipino or Asian?
Depends on who you ask.
Yeah, that's right. Ask an Asian, they'll tell you no.
I'm Chinese.
Yes, ancient Chinese secret. So, we'll find an hour for you, perhaps Thursday or Friday. Sound good?
That's
okay,
really
good. Hang on. There you go, man. All paid off. What do you know? Mm-hmm.
See that persistence? You just got to keep going at
Let
it.
Let me tell you, perseverance wins in the end.
T-Man. Where do they teach you to talk like this? In some Panama City sailor want a hump-hump bar? Sell crazy someplace else. We're all stocked up here.
Yeah, T-Man here. Hanging out for a few weeks, being a daddy. Hey, easy now. Oh, Lord. Spit over here. I'll be back in a few weeks. I'm going to take people out there in the listening audience to Vegas to celebrate this little bundle of joy. Stop crying!
I don't have $50,000. Okay.
I'm sorry, I lied to you.
Evan's moment of truth had finally arrived, and TV viewers were riveted to the unfolding drama. Over 42.5 million people tuned in to the last half hour to see how his would-be princess would react to the deception.
It's a pretty big number. That's like the biggest show in the history of Fox TV. 42 million people.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm. What was that now, Stephen? I heard
it's crazy.
Crazy.
Oh.
That's almost 800,000 more than watched last year's Academy Awards.
I'd like to continue the journey.
That's what's crazy. That, yeah. That many people are watching the Academy Awards. That is the most boring show in the history of TV. Best lighting. Riveting.
Let's see what happens.
Made-for-TV happy ending, Evan's financial status was not important to Zorro.
All right, yeah, we all know, whatever.
That's garbage.
Oh! An editorial comment from The Bachelor!
Why would she have entered? Why would she have been on the show?
Maybe she has different motivation than the average woman. Maybe she has different motivations than you.
Maybe she liked the dumb guy.
No, because every time she would receive a necklace, did you see her face? Look at your necklace. Can I just see yours?
Well, she wasn't one of those.
If they would have put an ad out.
Inspired by a necklace. The others did. She was selected by Evan with all his genius inside because she was not the one fawning over every piece of jewelry that was sent her way. She's a substitute teacher. Need I say more?
I don't know. That's why she wants a man with money.
Oh.
I don't know. If they would have put an ad out, meet a broke man.
Mm-hmm. She wouldn't have.
Have a good time.
She wouldn't have responded.
No. Mm-mm.
Even the substitute teacher that she is.
No.
If they would have put out a newspaper ad with his picture that said, completely broke, but loads of fun, she would not have responded.
No.
And you get to spend a month in France and stuff?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-mm.
Well, he's not broke. He makes $19,000 a year.
Well, you throw out the France part, because that was part of the duping of the women.
Yeah.
But would love to go out for an ice cream cone.
Magic Mountain.
Make $19,000 a year, loads of fun, honest, upstanding man. She's not responding to that ad.
No.
She responded to ads about a show called Joe Millionaire, where she heard a guy who inherited $50 million was looking for a bride.
Right.
So that was enough to convince you that she's a money-grubbing, gold-digging bitch.
But that said, she still fell in love with the guy,
though. No, she did. How? No.
Her line, when he told her that he didn't have any money, her line was, what a relief, because the money thing was bugging me. You think that is a load of crap?
Yeah, what was she going to say? Oh, I'm out of here.
Mm-hmm.
No, she had to play it off.
With the cameras rolling, she had no choice.
I give him 3 months.
Well.
Or until the money's up.
It's amazing.
Do they have to split that? Because it said Zora and...
Yes, it said the Zora and dude. And it was interesting when Evan Joe Marriott, whatever his stupid name is, idiot that he is, it was amazing that he said, hey, that's $500,000 apiece. He wasn't even considering them a couple.
Yeah. That was weird.
It wasn't like, hey, we get $1 million. The new great couple that we are that's going to live forever. No, he was talking about, hey, you get 500, I get 500. See you.
And he folded that up and put it in his wallet. Like, you can really cash that.
Any bank will cash it, Steven.
Yeah, he's going to try.
Because that butler has good credit.
I don't know. I think he picked her because of her angle. Not showing any skin.
Oh, jeez.
His family was watching. She's the only one out of the finalists that didn't.
All the mistakes you've always made all your life. Is that what you're saying, Constance?
Yeah. You know?
Well, it's a good angle.
That's what's
works.
Wrong. I don't know.
I don't know. She was pretty easy to get into that hot tub. But every woman on reality TV is. It's amazing how every woman falls for the hot tub.
Jump right in.
And most that aren't on TV do too, I think, actually.
Right? Have hot tub women jump? Is there a hot tub a woman has turned away in this world of ours or what, Constance?
I don't think
so. You ever turned away a hot tub?
Nope.
Oh!
Yes.
She falls for it every time!
Every time!
So in that ad about the poor guy, you need to put hot tub.
Hot tub.
That Constance is in.
Apparently, if you can spend your last penny on affording a hot tub, it is well worth it because no woman in the history of this planet that we call Earth has ever turned down a hot tub. That's right, I said. A hot tub. Now, Constance, you are here this morning in replacement of Terry Free.
Mm-hmm.
You are here as a co-host fill-in extraordinaire. That means you are required to find stories that may interest us. Now, Ariola did a splendid job yesterday. It's going to be a tough... Why are you laughing?
I like her.
It's going to be a tough act to top.
I like her.
She is loved by the listening audience, and a fan club has already started.
I know, I heard that.
Mm-hmm.
Do you have a fan club?
Do you have a fan club?
I don't think so.
Is there a Northwest chapter for Constance?
No.
Not that I've heard of. So I don't think giggling at the name Areola is something you need to be doing.
Mm-mm. I do like her.
I don't think she really cares.
Okay.
She has never asked us, hey, what does that Constance think of me? I don't think she really cares. But what we do care about this morning is that you do your duties that were spelled out on the 24-hour contract that you signed on your way in the building.
Okay.
Did you ever your lawyer look at that?
Sure did.
Okay. You want to hit us with your first story this morning?
I do.
What do you have?
Seems...
Not interested.
No, yes, you are. This is good.
Okay, what is it?
This is good. It's about J-Lo.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, what are you, Terry Free now? You have to start with a J-Lo story? Go ahead. You think Terry Free's new husband is trying to untie her tubes right now?
I think he is.
Come on, Terry, put your fingers on. Is that the first order of business in their marriage?
Oh, they did pack needle nose pliers.
Wow.
So
oh, wow.
They got the home kit.
I think I'm going to need a Phillips head here.
Wow. That's unbelievable. Terry Free. A married woman.
How long do you think it'll be until she's pregnant?
3 weeks from never. I don't know. What are the odds? Want to take bets right now?
Yes,
I
do. Pretty amazing that they're doing that.
They're untying
Risky.
Her. What are they doing? They're in vitroing her?
Yeah.
That's a terrible thing.
Are they really?
No, actually, yeah, they're going to plant a seed without untying her tubes.
Going to walk in the garden
we
and
just
plant
a
seed.
We just tease her about untying her tubes. They're going to take his little spermies. And they're going to do drop them into her wherever.
Into her wherever.
Yes.
That'll be the uterus.
With a turkey baster.
They're going to buy a super soaker and
right.
Pump it up really hard.
That's right.
Squirt it up in there.
Jeez. So I guess it's going to happen.
Wow.
It's a can't miss proposition, right? When you turkey baste it right in there.
Right.
So are we doing kid or no kid? Is that really what the bet is?
I don't think it's kid or no kid. It's how quickly Terry Free comes in and tells us she's Prego.
So we're convinced that she's going to be pregnant at some point.
Yes.
Yeah, there's no question.
Hmm? And then how quickly after her pregnancy she gets lipo.
No.
For free from a plastic surgery. Right. We hear her doing commercials for the next 6 months after that.
Again.
Right.
God, we should all be so lucky to have lipo twice for free.
24-hour fitness wasn't cutting it for me anymore, so I went straight to lipo.
Why would you go on the treadmill and people could just suck it out of you?
Right!
How kind of sense is that?
Mm-hmm. Why wake up at 4 in the morning when you can sleep all day? So, want to take bets or no? All right,
yes.
Later. Let's hear the J-Lo story. What do you got?
Okay. Looks like she's forced the entire cast and crew, including Robert Redford, to move her movie from Calgary to Vancouver just to be closer to Ben.
Wow. She's shooting a movie right now?
Yeah.
With pockmarked Robert Redford?
Another romantic comedy.
Are they going to get romantic together?
I hope not.
Mm-hmm.
Gross.
Mm-hmm.
Made in Vancouver.
So Calgary's kind of far from Vancouver? I don't know my Canada layout.
I think so, yeah.
I think it is, too.
Calgary's in the
Is
east.
That kind of clingy in your mind, Constance? Is that what you're thinking?
That's a clingy
move by J-Lo to... Mm-hmm. And it's amazing. She has that power that Robert Redford has no choice but to move his situation over to Vancouver because J-Lo needs to be a little closer to bed so she gets her nightly kisses.
Yeah.
Or so he doesn't get his nightly kisses from somebody else. I think it's really
That's
problem.
Exactly what it is. She's doing too much with that
She's
one.
She's concerned that Ben is going to, if you're not with the one you love the one you're with. Since he's not with J-Lo, he'll be with someone else.
Mm-hmm.
What is he doing near Vancouver?
Yeah, what's he?
He's filming a movie there, too, I
he
think.
Is.
Yes.
Yeah, he's up there for
So time. Now they're filling dual movies in the same area because J-Lo made it so.
Yeah.
And that's a clingy kind of, are you suggesting a insecure move on J-Lo's part? Is she an insecure woman with all she's got? With all she's achieved.
When it comes to her men, yes.
With all the notoriety she's gathered all through the years now. She is still as insecure as any woman out there, is what you're saying, who has a man that she may be insecure about. She is no different than any woman who follows her husband around, who follows her boyfriend, who checks up on boyfriend at times, calls him at work, make sure he's there. She's the same type of mindset as that woman.
Guess so. Guess so. Well, when you go from P. Diddy, she couldn't take it that he was always busy out with other people. So then she went to her backup dancer so she could always be with him. He would always, you know, be right there.
A sad state of affairs.
Yeah. Now she's at a happy medium.
And who pays for it? Robert Redford.
That's right. Of all the people to hurt. What did he do?
Mm-hmm. How did he get thrown in the mix here?
God, who knows?
He's packing up everything right now.
You plan on filming a movie for 10 months somewhere.
Mm-hmm. Oops, got to go somewhere else.
Jeez. Constance has already said more words than Areola did yesterday.
Oh, geez.
Yeah.
And yet she said nothing. Is there any way to slice it, Stephen Kilbreath, other than what Constance has offered here, that she is very insecure, very clingy? Or can you give us a different spin on why she might have moved everything to Vancouver?
I mean, she may just like the guy, too, and want to be near him. And if they're able to move it to Vancouver, I mean, you know, it's all Canada. I mean, no big deal.
Stephen suggests she just likes her soon-to-be husband.
But
and she wants
be
to be around him. And it's not about checking up on him or being concerned that he may do things that would be a violation of their relationship. It's just simply proximity. She doesn't like being so far away from the man she loves.
They're still working
every day.
Is there
anything wrong with that? Yes, there is. And its name is Robert Redford. They were shooting in Calgary. That's her job.
Mm-hmm.
That's true. I mean, it probably should stay then.
What is Stephen going to say? That's why Amy started working here. Stephen needed to be as close at all times as possible.
Because Amy was loving the one she was with.
You know, wasn't my eye on things.
Wow. Robert Redford works here now, too.
Yeah.
Interesting. So they start shooting in Vancouver ASAP.
Yeah.
She was able to... She has enough power that they all said, all right, we guess we got to move to Vancouver.
Yep.
It's either that or lose J-Lo in the movie.
Yeah.
And what's the difference between one province in Canada with the other?
Yeah, they're all the same.
Canada, Toronto, Vancouver. Who the hell's going to know?
Take your pick.
Yes.
That's terrible.
Very well done. Terrible.
Terrible. It'd be more romantic to get together on the weekend or when you have a couple days off, not be in each other's face like that. How can she work? Because I've seen her do a couple movies and, you know, behind the scenes.
So there's never going to be, there's no chance of any guy that she, wait, let me finish my question. There's no chance of any guy you've ever gone out with calling the program now and saying, Constance smothered me. What the hell is she talking about?
No, no. Mm-mm.
Because, hey, last I checked, you were dating one of the guys who was very interested in you through the Bitchler situation that we set up here on this program. His name is Tony. Tony currently, last I checked, is on the show Am I Hot, by the way.
Correct.
Does he need America to tell him they think he is or isn't?
Oh! Hello, insecure blow!
Yeah.
Sounds like she's had trouble getting on some reality shows.
All right, here's the deal.
I need it if anybody cares.
Tony's doing well, from what I heard on Am I Hot? He's hanging around. Have they done, like, I watched like 15 minutes of the first episode. Did they eliminate people already? On Am I... All right, Weeman's the authority on this.
They do it from
He watches all the time. He's waiting for the 5 foot five and under. Am I Hot? Yes.
They narrowed it down to like 32 people from four different regions, southeast, northeast, northwest. Tony, I believe, made the cuts from the northwest, but they haven't done that episode yet where they
But Tony's alive as far as representing the northwest.
He's breathing, yes.
Yeah.
Alive and kicking and breathing.
Yes.
And that's killing you.
He took off his shirt and took off his pants, too. Just was nothing but his boxer briefs.
God.
You know...
Somebody spare me.
You know you were way into him.
No.
We heard through the radio grapevine, Constance, that you were way into him.
From Tony. Did you hear that from Tony?
We heard it from Tony.
Yeah.
And he said you were way into him and got a little bit, too. And here's the word that we just used for J-Lo. Clingy!
Good
Clingy!
Lord. That is so far from the truth.
Can we get Tony on the phone?
Please do.
Tony's alive and Am I Hot, and you are sitting at home. Since things didn't work out between you and him, you are praying that America dismisses him as non-hot. Mm-hmm. Because if he went on to win this thing, how bad would that make you look?
I don't care.
Does he have any chance to win this thing?
Maybe. No, I'm not saying Tony's not beautiful. Physically, he is.
Oh, geez.
But as soon as he opens his mouth, nothing.
Oh, Lord!
That's not what the show's about.
Exactly. Nothing.
Am I smart or not?
So
not
that,
the show.
You know what I mean? So he might win. God bless him if he does.
What about when he wore a tux to the in-studio Christmas
Make
party?
Make me
that,
sick.
That killed you?
Make me sick.
Oh, geez.
The T-Man.
He's a very strange young man.
He's an idiot. Comes from upbringing. Parents are probably idiots, too.
T-Man in the morning here. Taking a little time off of the busy schedule. Hope you enjoy the best T-Man. I'm being... Mr. Dad, Mr. Mom, Mr. Everything. Don't you know right now, and I'll be back soon. And when we return, we're going to load up a plane. We're going to head listeners and ourselves down to Vegas to celebrate. Yes, we're going to celebrate. What are you thinking? Ah, baby. Easy now.
I am sexy. I am perfect. You know, all that anger is going to make her somebody's ex-wife.
Oh.
Guaranteed.
Mm. My name is Ivy. I'm really hot.
Shh, don't talk. It's ruining it.
Right.
You're very sexy.
Thank you.
And I like your choice of clothing.
Thanks. I just feel like the hair is a little Milli Vanilli.
I was actually thinking a little more Bo Derek.
Oh, geez.
I don't care about the clothes because I'm imagining you not wearing them anyway. Yeah, she's hot.
Some of the highlights of Am I Hot, the program that Tony, who was in The Bachelor, is now trying to rise to the top of.
So who from the Northwest will advance to the next round of competition?
I wanted to come off as, you know, kind of funny, but they didn't take it like that.
It kicked my butt. Lorenzo said that I have saggy breasts. I think I have a great body.
This is Hollywood. How can lips be too big for a face?
Oh, geez.
Hello.
I want everybody to know that I am gorgeous.
Oh, Lord.
Okay.
Let us recap where we've been with Constance this morning, who's filling in for Cherry Free on their honeymoon, day number 3 of her honeymoon, I believe, something like that.
You're real dialed in her honeymoon.
Whatever. Yes. And Constance, we were just informed by her through her story reading. She believes J-Lo is very clingy, in her opinion, because she had the entire set of the movie she's filming move from Calgary over to Vancouver so she could be closer to Ben. I follow it up with, well, have you ever been clingy? Is there any chance that you're pointing the clingy finger over at J-Lo? Is there any time in your life where you could have been described as clingy by any of the guys you went out with? And she said, absolutely not. No chance. And I then said, well, isn't the reason that you and Tony didn't work out because you were getting too clingy too quickly with him? Good. Isn't that what he told us?
That's what he said.
You don't see it that way.
Not at all.
You and Tony didn't work out through your meeting and grading and trying to begin a relationship on the program of The Bachelor because why? Why didn't you and Tony work out in your opinion?
Too different. He's... like I've said, everyone's seen him. He is beautiful. That's fine.
Right.
But he has nothing going on upstairs.
Ow!
He wears tennis shoes with dress pants. I can't move past that.
You're deeper than beauty.
Deeper than beauty. I'm down to the shoes.
Yes. Well, isn't it ironic that after, apparently, according to Constance, Tony got dismissed by her.
Mm-hmm.
He is now rising up the ladder of the show, Am I Hot, representing the Northwest, and supposedly doing quite well.
Good.
Supposedly, he took off his shirt, and Hotshot, who watched it, said one of the judges, the female judge,
yes.
Hopefully.
Yes.
It wasn't Lorenzo Lamas?
No. Was it Rachel Hunter?
Doubled,
is she a judge?
Doubled over in delight.
Yeah, she like put her head down on the table like she couldn't believe what she was seeing.
She couldn't believe it because why? Tony, he's kind of skinny, isn't he? He's got like a chiseled body under that clothes he wears and stuff like that, under the tennis shoes and all the baggy whatever.
Mm-hmm. And he lifts. You can tell he's got a little bulk to him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So Constance,
mm-hmm.
who dismissed Tony, at least according to her testimony, is obviously praying at home in front of the TV that he does not do well on the show.
No,
because if he does do well, how bad does that make Constance look?
Okay, not at all.
How bad does that make Constance look if he goes on to, let's say, win this whole thing?
Oh, please.
He's not going to win this whole thing?
No. For the Northwest, have you seen what the Northwest is working with?
Ow!
Come on.
So he may do well in the Northwest, but that's not representative of how well he'll do in the country.
I am not saying Tony is not beautiful. He is very good looking.
Oh, geez.
Now.
Well, that's what it's all about on this program.
The Northwest men selection?
Right.
Burnt out.
Oh, Lord.
Mm-mm. No.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to the rest of the world, look at Miami, look at New York,
so
LA.
Tony, as good-looking as he may be compared to the other guys in the Northwest,
he would be semi-okay in, like, L.A. or...
hold a candle to some of the Miami guys.
No, not at all.
Well, isn't it interesting that right on the line right here, ladies and gentlemen...
is he on the line or not?
He's on the line.
Okay. Wow.
New show.
We met him during the Bachelor mornings. He went out with Constance. We set him up on an elaborate breakfast that we paid for.
Lucky for him.
And now he is becoming a global star on the show, Am I Hot? Good morning, Tony.
Morning, sir.
How are you?
I'm doing pretty good. I need to know when on earth I wore sneakers with Jess Fence. I'm really getting tired of
On a date, Tony?
When did this occur?
On our date. You were wearing
on that date. I wore jeans, honey.
Tony,
maybe in your little white trash world, dress pants. But where I come from, jeans are kind of casual.
Tony, honey, where do you work exactly? You're a bouncer.
Oh Lord.
Okay.
Well, he's not a bouncer anymore. He's on the program Am I Hot?
Well, he don't get paid for that.
It's a full occupation now, though.
Okay.
He can get a lot. Tony. If he does well, the reality is, as much as you despise Tony right now, if
well,
he does well...
I'm going to pray for him, then. I'm going to pray for him, because there's no future in bouncing.
If you... if he does well on the show Am I Hot, like Evan Marriott, he's on every show, daytime-wise, nighttime-wise, he's on Letterman, he's on Regis and Kelly, he could really springboard into national stardom.
Good.
And his bouncer days are over.
Good.
When you see Tony on The View, you're going to be upset.
No, I won't be upset.
You will be upset.
I've never said that Tony is not good looking. I've never said that.
Mm-hmm. So why did you and Tony not make it? Because you, he dressed
inappropriately? He tried to say I fell in love with him. Make me sick.
He says you got a little too clingy. And it's ironic because you started this program with the first story you read by saying J-Lo's too clingy, and that's not a good thing. And
so therefore,
I want
hence,
you to be...
I would not be like that.
Well, I think you should admit more of the reality of it took one to know one, as opposed to you saying
the only,
that I never do that.
Okay, the only occasion I could think maybe be me being a little clingy, and if my ex-husband's listening, he might agree, is towards the end of our marriage. I didn't know how to step out and be a single mother on my own. But that's completely different than just wanting to be up under your man.
But you were never, ever even remotely clingy with Tony.
Never. No.
If anything, you were pushing him away.
Okay. Please trust me and believe in this.
Yes.
That man wore tennis shoes with dress pants, and I don't care how many times he honeys me this and honeys me that. Make me sick. That's not my style at all. Not,
Tony, it seems to be a he said, she said situation.
He hides behind his car.
Oh, Lord.
Come on now.
She says dress pants. You say jeans.
He drove past my first date in his car. That should tell you who's clingy.
Good point.
That is true.
Get on.
But, Tony, as we speak right now, Constance is not really a concern of yours. What is a concern of yours is how you're doing on this program. Am I hot? Are you still around?
Yeah, I'm here. I mean, as far as the show goes, there's like this huge contract we have. I don't even know what the heck I can talk about or can't talk about.
Read it, Tony. Left to right.
Well, just talk about
left
what you
to
want.
Right.
Group works together in sentences.
Wow.
Have your dad or mom help you. Sit down, take some time.
Why, Tony, is there such hostility from Constance to you? Why do you think that is?
Because he lied. I was never clingy on that man ever.
Okay, we're sitting at wherever we went out to eat. I don't remember because it's not that important to me.
Oh, geez.
I'm not talking about on the show. I'm talking about
our
after
about.
Date.
Okay.
She's like, on the bits for morning, you know, when you came up, I was so nervous because...
Tony!
Just, all right, wait, let Tony speak!
You and you're so, this and this and this, and I'm just like, okay, psycho, get away.
I'm about to show you psycho.
Psychopath!
Tony, anyone that knows me knows I don't... Oh, I'm nervous. I'm not nervous for anything. The morning I came... The very first time I came down here, you can ask anybody. I was like, if I make it, I make it. If I don't, I don't. I would never be intimidated by you or nervous by you because you're trash to me.
Okay.
So please stop because you sound crazy.
I really
you're silly.
Care.
Okay, wait a minute.
Okay, that's why you're hanging on to it. That's why you taped every show. Did you or did you not tape every single show and send it back to your
because
family?
Because I was there to be on the radio. I think it's kind of pathetic that you were actually there to find a man.
Desperado, blow!
Okay, so you think by being on the radio and then being on TV so you can get America to call you sexy, you're going to find a woman? Is that your angle?
No, it's to have fun because I'm young, good-looking, and I'm going to enjoy it while I
Tony,
can.
Tony, I think
you're
in love with yourself.
You're just saying, I need a man, I need a man. I better hit up all and
every media. I never said I need a man. I said I'm a bitch, and I want to find a man that can deal with that. I never said I need a man. Let me tell you what, okay? I do not need a man to justify anything I do. Believe that. I have more upstairs in my mind, Tony, than you can ever foresee in your life.
Wow.
All right, well, and so if it makes you feel better to sit here and try and make me sound like I'm good-looking and stupid, you know, then go right ahead. But you know damn well that I'm working on both of my degrees.
All right, now,
I've got a lot more going on upstairs.
In all honesty,
I challenge you to some kind of an intellect competition.
No problem.
Yes!
No problem.
That's a good idea.
No problem. Anytime.
Tony, are you available to come down later this morning for this intellect challenge?
This morning?
Yes.
Yeah, what time would you like me?
We would like
preferably
you to...
before 10.
Oh, Lord.
Wow.
Hang on the line, and we'll see if we can set up an intellect challenge for like 8:30 in the morning.
With some flags, some tennis shoes.
Yeah, are we smart enough?
Yeah, we have nobody to get the questions for. Who's going to do that?
We'll figure something out.
Basty?
Jeez.
All right, Tony?
Sounds good. Go ahead. Put me on with
Lehman. And honestly, I mean, it seems like it is Constance's angle to go for the he's all beauty, no brains kind of situation for Tony. Paint that kind of picture. But Tony has never displayed, in reality, anything that would lead anyone to believe that he's of subpar intelligence.
Okay. Do you hear what he just said?
What did he say?
Oh, there's a big, long contract. I'm not sure what it said. Read it.
Mm-hmm.
Read it left to right. Top
sometimes
to
contracts contain a lot of legal mumbo jumbo.
Well, he goes to
that
college,
is...
and he should know how to read.
Not necessarily. You could go through 6 years of graduate medical school, whatever the case may be, and not be able to break down legal type mumbo jumbo. I don't think it is necessarily representative of Tony.
No, but I think they'll put it in layman's terms for the people, or have someone explain
it
to them.
Last thing they want to do is put it in layman's terms. They want there to be a lot of ambiguity for Tony to be unclear so he doesn't do anything in fear that he might disqualify himself.
But I don't know.
I've read the entire contract extensively.
No, we don't believe that, Tony.
Yeah,
no,
we don't. I have highlighted,
all right? Do you even know what extensive means?
I have the
means?
Whole thing all read and highlighted. I'm just watching my ass, all right?
Mm-hmm. And I understand
you
that.
You watch that a lot, don't you, Tony?
Wow. All right, in the mirror?
You love yourself, don't you?
Probably about half as much as you do when you had you and your friend were begging me to take my shirt off.
Oh, wow.
And what I say, Tony, show me what you're twerking with. That's what I said. And you were happy to go in front of the mirror.
Show what? What did you say?
Oil
show
yourself
you
up.
You asked him to what? What are you, ludicrous? Show me what you're working with?
Wow.
You asked him to show you what he's working with.
Yeah.
So when he says you begged him to take off his shirt, he is not lying.
No, I didn't beg him. I asked him.
Well, you said show me what you're working with like
that's,
right?
That's correct.
But then he oiled himself up?
No, I don't know. He went in the bathroom and came out after like 10 minutes and then he was ready. So I don't know if he was in there lifting something or flexing.
He's probably
or
doing push-ups.
Putting some eyeliner on, I'm not sure.
Well,
yeah, okay,
body
good
shading,
memory. That's too
bronzer.
Bad your friend was in there, you know, giving her, I don't know, probably her illegitimate kid a bath, not yours this time.
Oh, man.
You know what, Tony? She's been married
hard,
for 6 years, so.
It's kind of hard for me to go in the bathroom when she's in there giving her kid a bath, but good memory.
Tony.
Isn't it amazing how well a match we are able to make through the Bachelor?
We really don't know what we're doing,
how terrifically people are getting along through the little proceedings on this program. Obviously, this one worked out well. Tony and Constance are both good-looking people when it comes down to it. Tony, obviously, better looking for a man than Constance is for a woman because he's on the program and she isn't. But it didn't seem to work out, nonetheless, between Constance and Tony.
Oh, well.
And now it's come down to Tony having to challenge Constance to some kind of brainiac little intelligence contest to decipher once and for all if Tony is an airhead good-looking dude or not. Hmm. And if he's higher with intelligence than Constance is as we speak right now.
But I have so much more life.
You looked a little
experience.
Scared. You looked a little scared when he challenged
anything.
You to that
no,
kind of contest.
I'm ready.
You looked a little frightened that after
no.
all your words, after all your accusations, mm-hmm. all your finger pointing of him being the airhead, that he's going to blow you away
there's
in
no
an intellect challenge.
Nope.
Because how bad would that make you look if you lost to Tony?
I won't lose to him.
Didn't say that with such authority, did you?
I won't lose to him.
Then again.
Just watch. That's the only thing I can do is show you. I mean, he can bring it.
Mm-hmm.
So, I don't care.
So he should bring
care.
His brain with him?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Tony has no street smarts, no
but you didn't
sense
deny.
Of humor, no
oh, Lord.
Anything.
You did not deny that you begged him, or you at least requested strongly that he take off his shirt because you needed to see what was
yeah,
going on
yeah, because he kept saying, I work out, and I got to go to GNC and get my protein drink. And I'm like, okay, well, show me what all this is for. You know.
Did she say it like that, Tony?
Something like that. She's just like, we take shirt off, we take shirt off, and then her roommate's like, I can hear a roommate from back. Oh, wait for me to finish giving my kid a
first of all, that's not my roommate. Okay, let's get some intellect. I don't live with her. Secondly, Tony, why'd you give Gay some topless pictures there?
Why did I give Gay topless pictures of who? You? I don't know.
You gave Gay phone operator topless pictures of yourself, Tony?
What's that?
Yeah.
According to a note that was just passed from Jimmy Fred Wayman to Constance, who was giving her ammunition, apparently they're working together here. A gay phone operator must have informed Jimmy Fred Wayman that you gave him topless pictures of yourself. Why did you do that, Tony?
Star was over here, and we were talking to Gay on the computer, and he was begging for him. So I was
Star
like,
was
all right,
over
dude,
there.
Here you go,
oh,
whatever.
My.
Hey, I'm secure with myself. That doesn't bother me at all. I don't care. I have nothing wrong with, you know, I hold nothing against gay men. If he wants to enjoy a good body, the rest is good as much as the next, and... Why should he be deprived just because he's...
Tony, yeah. Hang on the line. We are going to set up for later this morning some kind of intellect challenge.
Yes.
Yay.
Do we have a name for it? Some kind of intellect challenge?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
It's some kind of intellect challenger. Starring the some kind of intellect challengers.
Should be fun. The war to settle the score. Constance's brain against Tony's brain. Something's gotta give. The T-Man.
It can't be bargained with. It can't be reasoned with. It doesn't feel pity or remorse or fear ever.
Down. Seattle's number one hit music station, Cube 93, and I know, if everybody who's calling to tell us we didn't do the dollar bill game had the correct dollar bills, well, you might be winners, so we're sorry we didn't do that just a second ago. Vinny, you have any numbers for us today?
I was actually thinking of 09 because it's the 9th. I don't know. That's the only thing I could come up with.
Okay, so we need a 93 and then a 09 somewhere else, or do you want them right in a row?
Somewhere else.
Somewhere else. Okay, somewhere else. 93 and a 09, 1-866-663-T-MAN. That's where Vinny is, and he can answer the phone right now and get a dollar bill winner on Seattle's number one hit music station, Cube 93, with the best of the T-MAN.
There you go.
My whole life I've been fighting to want to belong, wanted people to believe in me and what I can do. And my trainers, my promoters, they believe in me, and it's great. It's a great feeling.
Tonya Hardy's been fighting the good fight. Now she wants to fight Saturday night. And twisting in the wind is one Tonya Harding as far as her first professional fight, because this Mike Tyson fight's been on again, off again, on again. Who knows what tomorrow will bring? Who knows what later today will bring? I'm done speculating. If I turn on the TV and it's on Saturday night, I'll watch. If not, who knows what I'll do?
I'm still going out of my way to watch.
Mm-hmm. Even if it's not on?
Yeah. Even if it's not on, Hotshot will create a Mike Tyson Clifford ATN fight in his living room. But talk about a battle. Talk about a war to settle the score. Yeah. For later this morning, in case you're just tuning in. Oh, did you miss a feud?
Yeah.
Between Constance and a man that she was once actually very interested in. You got to admit it. Physically. You liked him. Physically.
Mm-hmm.
And you cannot say that he didn't mentally do something for you. He's not a dummy. And that's why he felt he could challenge you and probably do really well. And make you look really bad, because that was your angle. Your angle was to propose to the listening audience that he's all looks and no brains whatsoever. So he says, okay, you want to go with that angle? I'll dispute it right now. Let's have an intellect challenge, and that we will have. Now he's called your bluff. That's called calling your bluff in the trade.
Okay.
And if you lose, cuz, there's going to be a lot of egg on that face of yours.
Okay.
It'd be a beautiful thing.
You're on the air. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
I was going to say that the J-Lo thing with her moving over to be closer to Ben, I don't think that's her being clingy at all.
Oh, yeah. That's what started all this. Constance accusing Jennifer Lopez of being very clingy.
What do you think it is? What do you think it is?
I just think that she has obviously the power. She's famous. She has the power to be able to move a whole set. And I think, yeah, she's taking advantage of that. But for her to want to be closer to the guy she's in love with doesn't make her necessarily clingy. If we had that power and our boyfriends were somewhere out of state, we'd want to be there too.
Well, maybe.
If only you had called about a half hour ago, you could have stopped this whole proceeding of Constance now having to worry about the questions we're writing for her intellect challenge.
And boy, coming from us, she should be worried.
I want to write questions that are, like, not brain busters. The hell, what fun is that? I want to write questions that are, like, middle of the road, that aren't gimmies,
right,
but certainly aren't going to be, like, Jeopardy questions that nobody can answer. Let's really find out who's not smart around here. That'll be fun!
Is that, like, current events or common sense things?
I'm writing them right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
You'll have to wait and see, Stephen.
I don't think common sense is really something we're dialed into, Stephen.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, probably not.
Oh, no.
But yeah,
tennis shoes with dress pants.
You got
to throw in a few common sense ones there.
You got yourself in a whole kind of situation because you called J-Lo clingy.
Right.
And this woman proposes a very interesting possibility here that she's just very much in love. And when you're in love, you want to be around the person you're in love with as much as possible.
Could be. But that's enough to make me sick. Every day, every day.
So when you fall in love,
day.
The more time you can spend away from that guy, the better.
Well, I don't know. You have to do you, and then he does him, and then you get together, and you give 100% of each other. I don't see
but
you
if you're,
being around
if you're,
each other all the time.
If you're working, you have to work, and you
correct.
Don't have to
don't mix the two. I mean, she should be worried about getting into character, focusing on, researching her character, that
so
kind
the
of thing.
Production is going to suffer. We, as paying moviegoers,
exactly.
are
getting
going
paid.
To pay the price because she can't get Ben out of her head.
That's correct. Not true.
Or maybe it'll inspire.
I don't know.
Hmm?
No way.
I don't know. I mean, she said she takes weeks, months before she starts shooting a movie to research the character.
Carla, what's your name?
My name's Rachel.
Rachel, is Constance just bitter or what?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know. I don't think
Does she sound
that,
like a scarred woman who can't find the right love?
I think that maybe she has her own insecurities.
Huh? Well, don't we all?
Well, I don't think it should be put upon somebody else who's doing the best that they can, and if they can make themselves happy by being close to the person they love, it's not for us to judge.
I don't know, and she could be right. She could just be flexing her diva muscles or whatever and trying to move it just to be a brat, but I don't think that's the case.
So either
given
way, she's
past,
either a brat or clingy. Either way, no matter how you slice it, she doesn't look good.
But she's doing her thing. She's
would you love to have diva muscles?
Yeah,
Do you have diva muscles right now?
To a degree.
What degree?
Not her degree. Not to that degree. I don't think anybody does. I respect her. She's,
We'd be in Arizona this morning if she had those muscles.
Right.
Yeah.
You're out of the air.
What's happening, T-Man?
How are you, sir?
Not too bad. Hey, I love your show. I've been listening for years.
I love your call, sir. Thanks for making it. Yes.
I've been listening for years. Those calls.
I have a couple of questions for Constance.
Mm-hmm.
First, do you have a, extensive social life?
As far as extensions,
I mean, do you have friends?
Yes, I do.
Do you? You seem like you spend so much of your time fighting with everybody.
No. In response to your question, I have a tight group of friends that have been there 12 years or more. I don't waste my time on these,
fair weather friends.
Friendship.
Right.
Yeah, I don't. I mean, if I
you have a couple
time,
of loyal ones, that's all you need.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So loyal that when Tony takes off his shirt, they come running out of bathtubs when they're bathing their
woo-hoo!
Children.
Yeah. That's
I see.
It.
And I got one more question.
Mm-hmm.
When you come on the air and you bicker with everybody and you tell everybody else how dumb they are, do you think you sound really intelligent?
I don't care.
Well, we're going to find out.
That's my opinion of him. That's my opinion of him. I don't care.
Do you think Constance starts all this stuff all the time?
Is it your opinion of him? Is it your opinion of him just because you're bitter because things didn't work out? That is what is obviously starting to surface in people's minds. Are you the type?
Got some problems.
Well, she would be.
I really don't care what you think, but okay.
Oh, she's starting up with you now, sir.
I don't care. Why would I care? I mean,
Constance, you know you're going to take calls from people that are obviously going to attack you because of the way you present yourself in this combative fashion.
That's fine.
So let's take more. Okay. You're on the air. Hi.
Hello. How you doing?
Good, sir.
Good. Hey, Connie. What's up? This is Damon.
Oh, my
God. Yeah, oh, my God. I'm sitting there. Check it out, T-Man. What's up, T-Man?
How are you, sir?
Hey, just to fill you in on what's cracking, man, me and Connie, we dated for about a
year. Wait a minute. You cannot say certain words that are against the policies of the FCC. So I had to dump that. But you dated each other for a year.
Right.
And you did other stuff.
Right.
Okay, now, just very quickly, let's get to the brass tacks here.
Right.
I asked her, is there any guys in the listening audience who may call and say, hey, you're pointing the finger at J-Lo, but you are the one who's clingy just as well,
right,
if not
that. And that's why this call is coming, because Connie, you and I both know when it comes to clinginess, you're very clingy.
Oh!
Wow. Well, and
J-Lo, exposure blow!
And I didn't. And I'm not trying. I'm not trying to front you up on the radio. Oh. But I'm just in my. I'm in the band, you know. And I'm rolling. And I hear you. And I'm thinking, come on now. You leave songs on my answering machine.
Yeah, to Damone I did. I'm not gonna lie.
Songs
to him
on my
at times.
Oh, yeah, Tim, it's a Damone I was clinging, if that's what you want to know.
No.
So, wait,
so the question... Constance left songs on Damone's answering machine.
But Damone was worth it.
Wait a minute. Is that something that is representative of clingy, or is that the kind of thing that is just a very nice gesture?
Damone.
Where does that fall in?
Damone, you never left a song on mine?
I left a song on yours, too. You know what I'm saying? It was back and forth. It was back and forth. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Was Damone's song "Leaving Worthy"? Does he have a big wiener? Where does he fall in? Is he a good guy that you were?
Damone is beautiful.
Oh, geez.
Damone is, without a doubt. I mean, he should be on that America's Sex. He blows Tony so far out of the water.
Wow.
This man is beautiful,
you know what I'm saying? And I'm no bouncer, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, thank you.
I need to see this cat, because I'm trying to see, you know what I'm saying, what level, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, really, you will laugh so hard, Damone. You will laugh so hard.
So what's all this? You didn't tell me all this about the date, about you and the dude went out. And
all right, now wait a minute, Damone. So you called things off after a year, or was it a mutual thing?
Well, it was one of them things where, you know, I wanted to do things in my life that kind of.
So you called things off. All right, you called things off. That's pretty apparent. And Constance was having difficulty dealing with that, so she was leaving pathetic messages on your machine,
basically,
crying, showing up at your door. Did she go that far or no?
Nah, I wouldn't say she went that far. Just the messages, you know what I'm saying?
So is that classic clinginess or no?
That, to me, is clinginess. To me, it falls.
She's rolling her eyes like she doesn't agree.
But honestly, I really feel that it was just me. You know what I mean? If it was another dude, I don't think that she's the type of person to be clingy
to
just anybody.
Because you're worth it, man.
Yeah.
Because I'm above and beyond, man.
Right.
You know,
I'm telling you.
I know Connie. And Connie, you know what I'm saying? She's very beautiful.
So when you say that, you are also giving us the impression that this Tony character that you're hearing about, when he says she's clingy, he's not right. She's not clinging with anyone but you.
Nah.
Damone, after one date.
She didn't even know the cat, right?
Mm-hmm. There's no way.
She didn't even know him. I know Connie, and she ain't going to be clingy to some cat she don't even know.
Nah,
Connie going to make him and break him. That's what she going to do.
There you go!
It's not clingy if she's trying to get him back.
Well, you left songs on his machine?
Yes.
Who left the first song?
What'd you leave?
Can't we
try just a little bit harder?
Sad.
Funny, cause he left Beat It, I think, was the one.
Right?
Let's come up with a list of songs that Constance could have left on Damone's machine.
Sad.
Damone was leaving. Yes.
A few Usher. Some Usher.
Right.
Glenn Lewis.
And Damone, did he leave? I said I loved you, but I lied.
Oh, sad. No, he didn't. No.
Get out of my life.
No.
Boom, boom, boom. Let's go back to my room.
Okay.
Oh, man. Sitting there with your phone to, like, some cheesy tape deck, leaving messages on Damone's machine, and you're calling. See, the questions, this all came about because you were so quick to point the finger at J-Lo, talking about clinginess. And I just said, hey, have you ever been clingy yourself there, Constance? And you could have said, well, of course, every woman, I'm sure, with some guy has been clingy. We could have moved on from this.
Then there
wouldn't have been this whole Tony conversation. Then there wouldn't be this whole situation that you're now very frantic about, having this intellect challenge against Tony later this morning. And then we wouldn't have to find out from ex-boyfriends that you are clingy.
No.
But no, you had to answer, no. I've never been clingy. That's not in my personality.
I don't consider it clingy. Once in a while, me calling him calling me. It was a mutual thing.
You don't think it's clingy to leave a message that he has to listen to that sounds like this?
Sad.
Oh, Damone.
Damone.
Moaney! Moaney, Moaney! Please call me back. I miss you so. Can we make it the way it was, Damone? I'll clean up the house. I'll make you food. Moaney!
You don't think this song sounds a little clingy to you, Constance?
That song does, yeah.
But this isn't the song you left? Oh, you left Usher.
Yeah. Hey, but that's a good song.
But this isn't one you left on his machine?
Not quite.
You would have him back if you did.
Maybe.
He would have come running to your doorstep.
No. This is the
sound of my... I always wanted to know what your soul sounded like, Hassus.
That's it.
Right. Wow, I hear those are expensive round trip.
Yeah. But now I've
come back again. Is that right? Why do I find it hard to write the What about that for an artist who's writing some musical lyrics?
Okay.
He's stuck on a line, so he just writes. Why do I find it hard to write the next line? Ah, the people got to eat this one up.
Good.
Okay. Not pathetic at all, Constance.
I don't care. Huh. I know
this much is what? True. Oh, true!
Dramatic. Okay.
I think that was a song you did leave. I think you're lying. I think if anyone's going to leave a song on someone's machine, it's going to be that one. Just
that
admit it. If you would admit things more openly and easily,
be easier.
Then you wouldn't be in the positions you get yourself in.
I like those positions.
Oh, geez, I bet you do.
Oh, man.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
Let's give it some more songs to try.
Oh, my God.
As T-Man plays DJ... Did Damone once come home from a hard day's work at whatever profession he is involved with?
Businessman.
Hang up the coat, put down the hat, stick on his answering machine, and hear this!
Oh.
Oh, my.
Yeah, I don't like this one.
But sometimes the snow comes down in June.
That's true.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. In Constance's heart, it does. Well, did Damone one day come home and stick on the old little blinking lighted machine and hear this? Oh, Moody!
You have 75 new messages.
Okay, they get the point.
No.
Well.
In my defense, can I speak on that?
No.
Okay.
You've already been convicted.
Right.
I'm guilty.
You're out of the air.
Hey, T.
Yes.
Constance, didn't you pick him? Didn't you pick Tony?
Yeah, I did.
So what's wrong with your choices?
Well, I only had like 3 minutes to talk to them. You know, I just basically
Well, maybe
asked,
you just didn't ask the right question.
In the social world, 3 minutes is a lifetime.
You had 3 minutes at breakfast that lasted an hour?
You think you don't know what you want?
You had 3 minutes, yes, to originally pick Tony. Then you went on a first date that we paid for. You sat there for an hour and a half, and then you decided to go out again with him because that went so well. And then you decided, oh, he's terrible.
Why don't you just be honest with yourself and say you just want somebody to bone you the right way?
Ow.
Wow.
Is that
you're
what you're
trash. Mm-hmm. I'm not even going to dignify that with a response. I'm a mother.
But you don't
I'm somebody's
have
mother. Don't speak at me like that. I'm somebody's mother.
What are you looking
are
for?
Are you? Act like it.
If you're not, if you're not looking for someone to bone you the right way, as
I'm
the
really
caller
not.
Suggests,
I'm really
then
not.
What are you looking for, Constance? You are a very single, very attractive woman who's got a lot of confidence in herself, who very well is able to defend herself with some of the most harshest accusations that I've heard in some time. Ariella didn't get calls this nasty.
And I like all the
callers. I mean, she didn't get called retarded,
boring.
But not this nasty. So tell us what a woman like yourself is looking for.
Same
and who out there can fill that role so that eventually on his machine you could leave this.
This is a good song. I like this song.
You immediately dispel the caller's accusation that you want to be taken for the nicest rides in the world. What is Constance looking for in a dream guy that, in your mind, I'm sure you haven't given up hope, exists out there somewhere? Well, we've been through this, actually, when she was on
exactly.
the bench.
Exactly, and it has not changed at all.
Right. Well, refresh us. You want
someone that tells the truth, doesn't have 25 illegitimate children, which means Star and Tony, out of marriage.
So you do frown
drama,
upon. You do
works. You know what I mean? Just has respect.
You do frown upon the classic single mom type position that she gets herself in. You had your kids inside of a marriage. If a woman out there were to get knocked up while she was single, that is something that you look down on? Is that
what
you're saying?
One time, I don't look down on it. But two, three, and four.
First time, shame on you.
Exactly.
Second time, shame on me.
Exactly.
What, Terry, the third time? What does that mean?
Shame on you and your family and everybody you know. But she's going to try again.
Tony!
Well, you better start brushing up on your middle of the road trivia.
Okay.
Middle of the road, that's all we can come up with.
That's
right. The T-Man.
This will be the high point of my day. It's all downhill from here.
There's a new wrinkle for Botox injections. A leading expert on the cosmetic treatment says people who have Botox injections may develop new wrinkles as a result. Dermatologists say people unconsciously recreate facial expressions in the area where the facial muscles are paralyzed. Botox, by the way, is derived from the botulism toxin. It works by temporarily paralyzing muscles.
So as far as our Botox party that we had about almost a year ago, oops. part as far as clipping, highlighting, cutting, getting prepared to read.
Okay.
What do you got, Constance? She's surfing. She's looking.
Oh!
She's hunting.
Okay.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
Here we go. This is good. This is good.
Right?
Oh, man.
During this weekend's blizzard over Atlantic City, it seems a bunch of people are trapped in the casino. Basically nothing else to do but gamble, and they're all losing.
They're losing their fortunes. See, that's fascinating.
That is.
Not really. People got trapped in the blizzard of the East Coast in the Atlantic City hotels.
Stuck.
No, nothing really
to do.
The gambling's available, and they're losing tons of money. But I would sue for it all back.
What if they're comping people free rooms at least?
You were in Las Vegas when 9/11 hit, and they shut down any air travel for about a week, right?
All the rental cars were gone. Trains are full.
But luckily for you, there's legalized prostitution in the state of Nevada.
That's right. That wasn't so bad.
In Atlantic City, New Jersey, there is no legalized prostitution. There's nothing for these people who are trapped in New Jersey to do but gamble in the hotels there, and they're losing a fortune.
You still don't have to gamble. Well, you kind of do. When you're stuck there, what else are you going to do?
What are you going to do? Sit there playing with sweet and lows? What are you going to do?
Sit in a room or something. Or, you know, take a walk in the snow.
Mm-hmm.
Take a walk on the boardwalk.
Take a walk in the snow.
You're out of the air.
Hi, I was calling about the Joe Millionaire Show.
Yes.
I just wanted to say that the black girl that they did have on that was a bitch. She said that she was daddy's princess and just wanted everything she wanted.
So oh.
It had nothing to do with.
So it was a justifiable elimination in your opinion.
Right, she was beautiful, I agree, but she...
Well, wait until black women get even on the player. You're out of the air, hello.
White guy gone.
Right. White guy's an idiot.
But then the country's outraged when he's the last one standing.
You're on the air, hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Hey, about the Joe Millionaire, you know, it's great that they have the black women and the white women, but what about the Hispanic women? What about the Hispanic
Well, UPN kids? Is working on a show called The Comedone. And that'll be on soon.
Well, that's great, but I think there's a lot of hot Hispanic women
that
are not out for the money, and that could be on any of those shows, but it seems like the culture or the society only wants to see black or white people and not
Okay, well, the hombre is going to be coming to WB real soon. So there's been no Hispanic people at all that anyone could recall upon.
Yeah, there really hasn't been.
On any of the reality TV shows.
Right, I agree. That's true. I agree. And T-Man, I love your show. I think you are awesome.
Who cares, you Hispanic woman?
Oh, yeah. So
bad. No one cares about you, obviously. Why should I care? I love Hispanic women.
Yeah,
are you kidding me?
They're beautiful.
Always have.
Beautiful.
Always will. And I just have to look 2 inches to my left.
Yeah.
And look at the cover of my Playboy.
Nice.
That says right here in bold print, the sexy ladies of Latin TV.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a two-word article.
No, there's a lot of pictures in there. I looked at that one.
Really?
They're hot.
All right, where are they?
Towards the middle.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm a little distracted right now.
Okay. Stop reading the article. This is towards the middle.
Remember the show AKA Pablo? Latin TV is at its finest.
Steven, I don't want to hear what you did in your youth with your brother in the basement. Nobody's...
The T-Man. Why do you shamelessly waste my time like this?
I don't know.
I'm taking some time off to be Mr. Mom, Mr. Dad, Mr. Universe, Mr. Everything.
I don't, you know.
But when we get back, shouldn't we do it in style? Shouldn't we load up a party plane and head on down to Vegas, run wild through the casino, smash through the strip joints, and maybe even drink a pina colada by the pool?
Mm-hmm.
It's the T-Man's party plane to Vegas, baby!
It's never happened before. Trust me, it'll never happen again.
Mm-hmm. But it's happening now. Who's going to be on the party playing to Vegas? We're going to fill that bitch up with listeners. Be sure to be listening so you can qualify for the trip so we can be at the crap tables together. Give me a honey, 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 give me a honey. 7-0. Ah. Yeah. Was laid down earlier this morning. There's no love lost between two people that met a few months ago on the Bitchler show that we had here in the big studio. It was Constance who earned her way through the votes of the listening audience to become the Bitchler. She chose from a lineup of dozens of guys, the three that were her favorites. There was one guy who actually stood out in the crowd amongst the three guys. That was Tony. They went on an initial date. They hit it off quite well. Tony was impressed with Constance. Constance was impressed with Tony. Tony even had a drive-by to spy on Constance on one of her dates with another guy. They went on a second date on their own. Things were going stellarly. Huh? Sure. And then the roof caved in. Now, Constance hates Tony. Tony hates Constance. The fact that Tony is doing quite well on the new reality TV show tearing up your television screens called Am I Hot is starting to really make Constance simmer. She wants him to fall on his dumb face. They were on the air earlier this morning, in case you missed it, ladies and gentlemen. Tony and Constance showing that obviously there's no love lost. Constance proclaiming that Tony is nothing but a decent-looking face with a dumb brain inside.
Yep.
Decent-looking or better than decent-looking? What would you say?
A little better than decent.
Better than decent-looking. Yeah. He's impressing people on Am I Hot. He's getting through rounds of elimination. You got to give him a little bit more than better than decent-looking. Yeah, you got to admit he's a good-looking guy.
He is.
And he's never given us any indication through the things he said on the program that he's a dummy.
You didn't go on two dates with him.
Mm-hmm. Really went on three. Don't be so sure.
Yeah, right. But Tony has come down because after he had taken enough of Constance calling him an empty-headed himbo.
Didn't say that.
More or less.
Just what he has in there isn't worth anything.
Tony fired back, "Well, I'm smarter than you, Constance, and if you want to put it down to some kind of intellectual challenge, I'm all for that." Mm-hmm. Well, that's where we stand right now. There's no time like the present. We put together a list of questions that should be all answered correctly to find out who the real dummy is. And that's the name of the game. Who's the real dummy?
Yay.
Ring it, Tony. Let's introduce our two contestants. First, we start with you, Constance. From Houston, Texas. Age 24.
Half a blonde.
Single. With two kids from a previous marriage. She have half a blonde, half a brown hair. She's known to you and me as the Bachelor and quite proud of that status. She's staring down Tony. Her look just went from a big smile to a scowl when she saw Tony walk into the studio. She's Constance. Round of applause! Woo-hoo! And maybe the reason you scowled is because back there sits a handsome man wearing a lot of cologne.
You don't shower, that helps.
Okay.
Tony.
About that 7 a.m. quick shower.
He's originally from Aberdeen, Washington. Age 23 years of age. Currently a big star on the program Am I Hot? Watching others be eliminated while he hangs around on the program Am I Hot? Tony, you weren't in the room when Constance admitted she hopes you fall on your dumb face on that program. He is Tony Bitchler, contestant to the stars.
Thank you.
And they are both here to play the game show that, you know and love. It's called Who's the Dummy? Now, Tony, you made it very clear. When it comes down to any kind of intellectual challenge, you believe you are a lot smarter than Constance, yes or no?
I am the man.
Mm-hmm. Constance, you believe that inside that head that has a lot of women turn their own heads looking in the direction of Tony is the brain of a dummy.
I don't know. You can't even look at me because you know you're a liar.
Huh?
Since you walked in, you're looking down because you know you're a liar.
Well, I kind of have a microphone in my face.
Okay.
So you're looking down to talk into it. Uh-huh. An interesting concept. You think he's looking down because he feels embarrassed because he's lied and he's stupid.
He doesn't feel embarrassed. Tony doesn't get embarrassed. He's too much in love with himself. Mm. He's like, I don't care.
Tony, are you in love with yourself?
Yes.
And
yes.
If so,
I spend hours on end just staring in the mirror. I actually turn myself on.
If so, is there anything wrong with that?
I'm just like any other person. I care about how I look. I take care of myself.
So why does Constance...
The rest of the day, I try not to think about it.
Why does Constance continually put you down in saying that you're so in love with yourself? Why does she seem to believe that?
Because Constance grabs one thing, whether it's a lie or the truth, like the shoes, and just holds on to it because she's too dumb to come up with anything else. Yeah, have you noticed how many times she's brought up the shoes, which
because
were worn with jeans?
No,
jeez, oh, am I too dressed up for you this morning?
Your shirt is tighter than mine. Okay. Your shirt is tighter than mine.
Are my sneakers okay with these pants?
Not
this
really, because you have a button-up shirt on with the collar and some sneakers.
Jeans.
Okay. Okay.
I'd love to take a lightning poll as to how many guys wear black shoes. With jeans.
And a button-up polo shirt that is skin tight. Let's take a lightning poll.
Let's not say we did.
Go ahead.
Because right now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to play the game. Who's the dummy? Constance and,
yes,
and Tony have challenged each other to determine who is the brighter of the two. Now, I have put together a list of questions that should all be answered correctly in reality. Maybe you have a little brain fart at some moment that you would not be able to answer all the questions correctly. But whoever gets more questions answered properly is going to be crowned the non-dummy.
Now, have our answers been verified?
Okay.
Our answers have been verified by the Board of Weights and Measures. It is completely accurate, Stephen R. Kilbreath, yes. Okay.
And these aren't gender biased. These aren't all guy questions, are they?
An interesting accusation already made by Constance. It is not questions about football.
Okay. Well, no, because that would be asked if it was four girls.
In what year did O.J. Simpson with a Heisman trophy?
Right.
Tony, you laid down the challenge. Constance immediately accepted. And here we now sit. I have a list of, I'm going to start off by asking you last seven questions each.
Okay.
And whoever gets more correctly will be crowned the winner right then and there. If there's still a tie after seven questions, then we'll have to start having toss-up questions.
Sounds good.
But it's time, ladies and gentlemen, to play the game that you know and you certainly love. It's Who's the Dummy? Who wants to go first?
Ladies
Who wants
first.
To answer the first question? Ladies
so
first.
Ah!
Oh, wow.
Hello, vagina accusation, oh, blow!
Your wit, it just overwhelms me.
He's overwhelmed by your wit.
Okay.
Are you witty enough? Answer question number one accurately. Question number one.
Are you nervous?
No, I don't care.
Can I get a buzzer for wrong answers and like a bell for right answers?
Oh, Lord.
It would add to the drama before I get to question number one.
The whip?
You look a little nervous over there, Constance from Houston, Texas.
No.
You're not nervous?
No.
Talk about a buzzer for wrong answers, and all of a sudden you got a little jittery looking.
You're up against the guy from Aberdeen. This is tough.
Where's the buzzer? All right, let me practice. All right, here's our buzzer. Ow! You'll hear that.
That's cute. Okay.
You'll hear that if you answer incorrectly.
Okay.
You'll hear this. No. You'll hear this if you get an answer right.
Okay.
Sounds good.
We start with Constance. Mm. She will answer the first question on Who's the Dummy. Tension is already building. Question number one. Who
Oh, I know.
Got it.
I want to make sure Tony's not looking over my shoulder.
Oh, yeah, he is 6'5".
All right.
The long neck.
Here's question number one. What state is directly south of Kansas? What state is directly south of Kansas?
I don't know.
Would you like to take a stab?
Nope, because I have no idea.
You don't want to sound?
Give me the buzzer.
No, you want the buzzer.
No, come on, just take a guess.
Take a guess. You may
pull it out of your tight little ass.
Now think about it.
What state is directly south of Kansas? That's question number one on Who's the Number.
Now, can he steal, or do we have rules for this?
I'm so fired.
No, he cannot steal.
Tony okay. probably knows is this, it, too.
Don't answer, Tony.
All right.
Nope.
Concentrate, you have 5 seconds. Throw a state out there.
Buzz me.
Throw a state out.
You got to throw something out there. Do you know any states?
She knows no states.
Yeah, what?
Ow! We have to put an X.
Okay.
For Constance. Okay. Can you keep a score, Hotshot?
Yes, I am.
Okay. Yep. Stephen's a dickhead has 4. Tony!
No.
Here's your question number one.
What's the answer?
Oh, the answer was Oklahoma.
Oh.
Stephen playing along at home, wrong. Dying to know.
Tony, did you know that?
No, I was going to say Nebraska.
Tony! Who invented the light bulb?
That would be Edison.
That is correct. That was way loud.
Yeah, that's really, really loud.
Make sure to make a note of that. I guess I'm the dummy. Tony has one answer correctly in the bank. Mm-hmm. Constance.
Yes?
What is the name of the First Lady of the United States? First and last, please.
Well, I know the last, obviously.
Okay. Give us that to at least get yourself started.
I don't know who's
the president.
And I said the one thing I don't know is politics. And you guys are like, ooh.
Well, this is
not I don't know
if
this would really
know.
Fall into the category of politics.
Bush is the president, so yes. We know Bush is the last name.
Okay, what's her first name?
God.
Is this gender biased?
No.
She's a big football star.
Yeah, right.
You need more time? Constance has requested more time on Who's the Dummy.
Like, I care about this. Okay, no. Buzz me again.
Oh, jeez.
Or just guess. Come on. Think of
ow! Constance is in the hole.
Ridiculous!
Here, and she's screaming at whoever is listening, and we all, I guess, are.
Ridiculous.
You have two questions asked and two
gone.
Incorrect answers,
I know.
Constance. You accepted the challenge.
Okay.
You were the one throwing spears.
It's not over.
Give her the answer just so she knows.
Alora Bush. Her name is Laura.
Oh, I thought you said Alora. I'm like, I would have never guessed that.
Alora Bush.
Think of Laura.
Tony!
Yes.
You're starting to take a dramatic lead in Who's the Dummy?
It's only 1-0.
Well, that's true, but the questions are dwindling down. Your question. Name 4 countries in the Middle East.
Iraq, Iran, Israel, and Istanbul.
Ow! Istanbul is not a country.
I thought maybe that was a city. I wanted to take that back right after I said it.
So that is an incorrect answer, Tony. Should have taken more time, Tony. It might have come to you that there's Egypt, Kuwait, Jordan, Lebanon,
Turkey,
many more.
So we know.
That's all I know. Algeria, Saudi Arabia, what else?
Yemen.
Syria.
We figured he wouldn't get any further than that.
Okay, yes.
Try around in Iraq. We thought he was done.
He has left the door open for you, Constance. He has left the door in Who's the Dummy wide open for you.
Counselor.
Here's your question. Ronald Reagan was the governor of what state?
Tony, do you know this one?
Oh, jeez. Constance, Ronald Reagan, who became president of the United States.
And didn't I just tell you I don't care about all that stuff?
Oh, jeez.
This one you could think about and figure out,
though. Okay, let me think. Ronald Reagan, who cares?
Because he doesn't remember?
Jesus, who did all these...
Constance, you're not doing very well.
Well, they're all on the same exact track. I told you that's the one thing,
Lord,
I don't know.
I promise there'll be no questions of any even type.
Buzz
of...
Buzz me again.
Oh, Lord.
Ow! You asked me one more presidential question. I don't know that stuff. Okay. I don't. I don't claim
to. She has
to.
Had two.
Put a little X by that question incorrectly. Unable to even give us an answer. Constance has not even attempted to give us one answer.
He had a 1 in 50 chance.
Mm-hmm. The state was California. He was the governor of California.
Tony, did you know that? Probably.
Pretty obscure state, I know.
Well, he was an actor.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, it stands to reason that he was from there.
Tony?
Yes.
Who played the original Godfather and won an Academy Award for his performance?
Oh, my God!
Al Pacino.
You give him those questions and I get...
Did he get it right?
Al Pacino?
Oh, the original Godfather, like way back in the day?
He answered. He did answer.
The answer was Marlon Brando. And you know what, Constance? You wouldn't have gotten it either.
Quickly. Take my full
5 seconds. You know, I'm thinking, and these are gender biased.
You like the first lady? The door again.
I don't think they are.
Is wide open for you, Constance. This is still anyone's game. So far, there's been one correct answer, and who's the dummy? After 6 questions.
These aren't gender biased, by the way. I think they're pretty standard.
No, they are.
Okay. Here's your next question, Constance. This one is of no political nature. And this should be very simple. I'm looking down the list for the easiest question.
No, don't. Come on.
All right. Do you want me to put that kind of pressure on you? Fine.
I'm already nervous. You guys got me nervous for these political questions.
Here's a question that's not the easiest one, but still, it's one you should get. And it's not gender biased. Who played Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz? Nobody cares! Ronald Reagan!
Hold on, 1939. Wait a second, I know this because...
Who played Dorothy? She went on later to commit suicide, and she has a daughter very prominent in the world still today.
I have her freaking autograph.
Oh, well. You haven't been able to read it for all these years?
Well, I don't frame it on my wall.
Right. And Tony wouldn't either. He's too busy having pictures of himself on the wall.
Right. In the room. Right.
The autograph.
Jeez.
Who played Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz?
Hold on, I know this. Hold on.
Constance, you're not doing well.
I know.
Do you want to phone a friend?
None of my friends would know that.
Well, we have a friend on the line.
He's a gay phone operator. He's so gay. He's so phone operator. And now, here's Gay. A good morning.
Good morning.
Don't give it away yet, Gay, but do you know the answer?
Well, I am a friend of hers.
Mm-hmm.
Gay, why don't you help me? Why are they doing this to me?
Well, you're the one calling Tony the big dummy all morning.
Okay, well...
You haven't gotten one answer right. Tony's gotten one.
He's the genius of the group.
Gay?
Yeah.
What should we do? Should we have Gay help her and then Tony can phone a friend?
No, Tony can phone me.
Ooh. Oh, jeez. No, Constance, this is your game. You have 5 seconds to answer this question.
Fire me.
Have help.
Go ahead, buzz me again.
Wow. Come on, guess. Meg Ryan or something. Throw it out there.
Oh, come on. Steven, I'm not stupid.
What if we give you the first name?
Okay. No, don't. Just buzz me.
She's too proud for help.
Who cares?
Ow! Everything she can't get, she says, who cares?
Right.
Because who cares?
Oh,
I mean, it's like way back in the day.
No.
Somebody cared.
Sad.
Judy.
Garland.
Yes. But still incorrect.
Well, you did sound smarter by saying Garland after Judy.
Tony, you can take a 2-point lead here. And the question is, what does the moniker... The letters FBI stand for.
Federal Bureau of Investigation.
Good Lord!
That's a political question, though. You wouldn't have gotten it.
Yeah. Government-type question. You hate
it. My 4-year-old son could get that question.
Right?
Come on.
Well, here's one for you.
No, I'm scared of your questions that you give me.
Who made the first American flag?
Betsy
Garland?
Ross? Something.
Yes!
Yes!
Wow.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, Constance is on the board!
Off the schneid.
It was not Al Pacino! It's 2-1.
It's a close race.
Mm-hmm. Actually, but I'm putting a check by one of your answers.
Okay.
Didn't know you could do that.
It's even sad. Just because you know all the answers.
I haven't known them all.
Tony?
Yep.
What is the capital of the state of Oregon?
Oregon, that would be Salem.
Ooh. Tony, not giving up his lead, showing the intelligence, for he is not a tummy! That was a tough one. Constance didn't look like she was burning with the answer there.
Didn't sound tough to him.
Oh, wait a minute. Did I just ask Tony two questions in a row? Or no?
No.
Uh-huh. Betsy Ross.
Right. Constance.
Yeah, oh,
you have to get this answer right.
Oh, what, I lose?
You may lose.
Oh. Hmm.
In what year? Oh, no, she's going to say this is a political question.
In what year? Oh, my God.
All right, I'm not going to give you that one. Easy.
How what year many, are we living now?
How, who cares?
It's political.
Constance, how many quarts are in a gallon?
Why do I even have to think about this? I look at a freaking gallon of milk every day.
Oh, jeez. Ronald Reagan.
Can't answer.
Math is too tough.
You can't answer?
No, Tony gave me the answer.
You didn't want to throw out a nut? What did he throw? What did he give you? He's giving you answers now?
Yeah.
Tony's feeling sorry for you.
That's sick.
Tony feels bad for you.
Don't do that.
Tony, who is screaming at you this morning, is now starting to feel bad for you.
Typical guy still thinks he's going to get laid at some point.
No.
You gave her the answer?
I felt bad.
Oh, man. So there you go. There you have it. I think it's pretty clear who the dummy is. Constance, you're a beautiful dummy. You're nice. You're a smart girl in your own way. Mm-mm. Maybe not for, like, questions that a relatively bright person would know, but in your own way.
Nice.
You're very bright.
Nice.
You're kind of bright. You're not very... I don't know what you are.
It's because just, I don't know politics. I mean, ask Tony. He knew some of my questions.
Gallon.
He probably... If you give me 5 seconds, Tony's over there like this. I could have said 4. You know what I mean? I was like, no, don't. Mm-mm.
Don't make it like you were getting that one. You were not getting it.
All right.
Should we give her one more? She wants to redeem herself.
No, don't.
She definitely she could have got it.
Nope, he won. That's good.
All right, the toughest question she got right, though.
Which one was it?
The flag one.
That was the toughest one?
Don't you think, out of all of hers?
No.
I think the Ronald Reagan one was my tough.
You didn't know the First Lady of the United States.
Okay.
You didn't know how many quarters were in a gallon, despite you thinking if you sat there, you would have figured it out.
I didn't vote for Bush, so I don't really follow his campaign and all that crap. I don't.
What's Al Gore's
wife's
name?
Name of Oprah's longtime boyfriend?
Stedman.
What time does...
Why do I get the remix of the buzzer?
What time does Eliminate come on?
11:30. Listen to Tony, he does. I think it's pretty clear who the winner was. She put up a good fight, Constance, not really. And it was quite the game, let me tell you. Gotta tell you. It was quite the tussle. Tony and Constance settling the score once and for all. If you'd like the home version of our game, call now 1-866-663-T-MAN. You want to apologize to Tony? Anything you feel the need to do or what? For calling him an airhead?
He probably is pretty smart. I didn't know he was... Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's big of her to, admit it.
All right.
Now, just to be fair, I've never felt that trivia was a good test of intellect. So I don't hold
still think he's
going to
get laid.
Of course he does.
Yeah.
I don't...
My God. You're completely pussy-whipped.
Now.
What is
you? So, Constance is filling in for Terry Frey today, who is on her honeymoon. Mm-hmm. Probably in the process of getting her tubes tied right now by her new husband in their honeymoon suite in Hawaii. Tony came down at the request of Constance to settle the score that became just a complete embarrassment. For Constance, who believes that she was not answered fair questions. Questions that represent the lifestyle of a woman who's 24. Is that what you're saying? I understand that.
It's okay.
Not many women have a Judy,
I'll take the loss.
A Judy Garland poster on their wall anymore.
Yeah.
Although you probably did as good as Terry would have. So right. If you're filling in correctly.
I wonder who'd win that one.
Next week.
Yeah.
Tony is on the program Am I Hot, and it's going to air the Northwest little version of Am I Hot. It's going to be on the
27th. 27th, 9 o'clock.
And you need people to vote for you?
I need, well, people vote online for.
Is
whoever.
He talking to the right side of the microphone?
Am I?
So. Oh. Go ahead.
Am I good? Okay, good deal. Yeah, it's on the 27th, and the internet voting opens after the show. So
how many people have they narrowed it down to?
Well, there's going to be 32 on the show. The judges have the job of narrowing it down to 8.
So by the time the show airs on the 27th, will it be down to 8 or still 32?
Well, the show at the beginning of the show, you'll have 32. By the end of the show, you'll have 8.
So you don't know if you'll be one of the 8?
I do not know. We'll
or is it,
just
has
have
it
to
been,
wait and see.
Has it been determined yet, or the voting that happens on that show will determine whether you get down to the 8?
Okay, I lied. I know, but I can't say.
So, in other words, you're suggesting, or you're making it clear without actually saying it, that you're one of the 8. If you read between the lines, you just admitted you're one of the 8.
No,
and
I just said
watch. Your contract.
No, I just
and
said.
And you're out of the competition now.
No, I just said.
So, after that show, they open up the voting to vote on the 8?
Yeah.
People that are left.
Yeah.
Okay.
And you are hoping that people out there vote for you through the internet.
No, I'm just saying, you know, there's a lot of good people in the Northwest, so put out some votes for them. There's a lot of good guys out there and girls.
And Constance made it clear earlier on the program that being down to the final 8 in the Northwest is no feat of any kind, because the people that are on the show representing the Northwest,
mm-hmm.
the men, are butt ugly.
Broke.
Are the people here just ugly,
I'm
or just the people
Tony's
on the show?
I'm not saying Tony's broke. I'm just saying that he, for the Northwest men...
Are
like
you
I
saying
before,
that the men of the North, the men of the Northwest in general, when you go out and about, when you
broke.
Hit the scene, are broke?
Broke.
You're
broke.
Saying the men of the
broke.
Northwest, so it's a fair representation
yep.
that Am I Hot has on their program mm-hmm. when they show the men of the Northwest. It's not like they just couldn't get good guys, but they're all around, and why couldn't they find them?
They probably
them?
Did find the
they
top.
They couldn't find anyone because there aren't any good-looking guys.
I'm not saying there aren't any. I just haven't seen a lot of them.
Mm-hmm.
You have to keep in mind, half of the guys were from, like, Denver. So
oh,
you,
okay.
That's Northwest?
Yeah, it's a huge region. I mean, it's like Washington, Oregon, Idaho, mm-hmm. Denver, Colorado, Wyoming.
So assuming you make it down to the final 8, which we, reading between the lines, believe now that you have, even though you didn't tell us anything technically, you will be the top 8 that includes states like Colorado and places like that.
Yeah, basically just the upper left corner of the country.
Okay, then what happens?
Region.
Then 8 from each.
I think that's a big accomplishment.
What?
Yeah, it's pretty solid.
That's good for Tony.
I thought it was like Oregon and Washington.
We knew him when.
Oregon and Washington.
When he was on The Bachelor a couple of months ago. Who knew he was one of the top 8 in the region?
We discovered him.
Thanks for the applause, but I'm going to, you know, you guys will feel dumb if you find out I didn't make it into the 8, but,
Well, you basically said you want people to vote for you.
No, I just said they should vote because, you know, I made a lot of friends in there and
right.
some good guys.
I'm sure you're really concerned about the friends you made on the hour that you were on the program. All right. So, Tony, it is our belief, we predict, ladies and gentlemen, that he's going to be one of the final 8. So,
mm-hmm.
if he is, he's hoping that you vote.
Right.
And even if he isn't, he has such close friends on the program.
Right.
He wants to make sure you get out your vote.
If you don't know who his friends are, just vote for anybody. He'll be happy.
It doesn't matter.
Name some of the people you met from the Northwest.
No,
he's such good friends.
Yeah.
I'm just pretty sure I've gone beyond my contract, so I'm just trying to shut up.
Just
now.
Sizing up the competition. Do you feel like you certainly hold your own amongst all the guys there, or is there one guy who's a standout that obviously has you beat?
There was one guy that aired on the first episode. I don't know if you caught it. The New York area. Dude was huge. I mean, it looked like you took just like clay and molded a body out of it.
Yeah, but it's not a muscle contest, is it?
So you're not worried about it?
No, but that's exactly what they said. They're like, dude, you look like an ape. You're too big. Get out of here.
Oh,
and they cut him.
Mm-hmm.
So he was gone.
But you're not worried about anyone in the Northwest region. And the guy who was big that you just talked about is gone. So who are you worried about?
No, nothing. I'm just saying that I don't know what they're looking for. So I don't know whether or not to be confident or not.
Don't you know, after living on this planet for over 20 years, don't you know what America is looking for?
Pick up Playgirl. They're looking for a new Playgirl.
Oh, jeez.
We'll see.
So no, what happens? They pick eight, and then what happens? You compete?
Then those people come back, you know. Well, then the internet voting takes place, narrows it down further. The people that go on from the internet voting come back.
That's fascinating. We'll watch the program. Yeah, I have some ST-man letters that I wanted to read with Constance in the room, since she seems like she likes to give advice to everyone, but she can't get her own life right. dear T-man, and this one I guess should have been read a while ago, as a Valentine's Day present to my girlfriend, I'm considering getting my name tattooed on my, her name tattooed on my arm. We've been dating for 9 months, and I figure we'll be married someday soon. My roommate tells me that she'll get totally creeped out if I do this. I want to be romantic. He doesn't think it is a romantic gesture. What do you think?
It's gross. I don't think tattooing someone's name, that's like something you do in prison. That's not going to prove your love to her. You could go and get that tattoo covered up in 2 years or turn it in, you know, a Beth into a Bethany or something like that. That's not romantic. That's not hot at all. You're messing up your body. That's not hot.
You would love a guy to tattoo your name on their arm.
No, actually, my ex-husband did. And then we discussed it, and he freaked out and went and got it covered up. And I was like, it's just not attractive. Right. I don't find it attractive.
You anti-all tattoos or just names?
They've only been together, just like the names and the big...
Yes, Marie.
Yes, she's right. I hate tattoos. Hello. Tattoos are trashy.
Tattoo.
Something tells me Marie doesn't have to worry about someone tattooing her name.
And well, the wayman already has her name tattooed on his ass. Marie?
Yes, sir.
What can I do for you?
Well, I just wanted to say...
Before I get back to more letters.
What?
Go ahead.
Okay. I just want to say that there should be more women like Constance, because men would not walk all over them. Yeah. If there were more women
who don't even know the name of the first lady, more women who don't even know what state Ronald Reagan was governor of.
Oh, whatever. She doesn't need
to
know
that. But you know what? I might not know
she has
that.
More women who don't know what...
She doesn't have to cover up with some facts that nobody cares
about. How many quarts are in a gallon?
Okay, she knows... You know what?
We didn't know until we looked it up.
That everybody knows that Ronald Reagan was president. And we don't need to know where he was born. But you know what? Men cannot stand women like this.
Right.
Because they overpower them. And men's egos cannot just stand it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, until you ask her a trivia question, your ego's fine.
I don't know.
Is that the reason you said you wouldn't be able to stand me for 4 hours?
Oh.
I can't stand you for 4 hours because you're just... nauseated.
Oh, really? Oh, why would that be?
Well, aside from the gallons of perfume, that's 16 quarts, do you know what I mean?
Come on.
4 gallons of perfume that you wear on a daily basis.
Okay, I promise I will not wear any.
Your personality tends to wear on people a little bit, wouldn't you say?
I don't think so.
You think your personality dazzles men, don't you?
No. Men cannot get enough of me. When they go on a date with me, they won't leave me. Or if they come to my place, they won't leave for hours.
But why do you...
They want to leave?
But tell me why... Tell me... You have to kick them out of your house.
Kick them out.
Tell me why you feel the need to wear so much perfume every time you come in.
I do not.
Does your cooch smell? What is it?
It depends. Maybe it has a strong scent to it.
What are you covering up?
I do not cover up anything.
You wear an abundance
of perfume.
You wear so much perfume, everybody that passes by you notices, and no one has the guts to tell you.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I don't think so.
I thought in Europe, where you're from, they didn't even wear deodorant or perfume.
Well, yeah, they didn't.
Exactly. Nobody has got to say anything to the other person that they're offended by or whatever, because, especially men. Men won't say anything ever.
I'm saying that you wear too much perfume.
Oh, come on now. I wore too much perfume once because I just put it on right before I walked into your studio.
And it always makes me think that you have a very stinky VJ.
Oh, my.
Wanted to be sexy for you guys.
Whatever, T-Man. Mm-hmm.
But, man, you're saying...
You sound like a typical man right now, you know?
Yeah, you say one thing of a critical nature to a woman, and I'm a typical man.
I don't know. Some men wear way too much cologne, too.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
And I pointed out that the first thing I smelled when Tony walked in the studio was his cologne. This morning.
That's true.
I have a very sensitive nose.
That's true.
And then we're going to smack the accent out of her.
Well, anyway, of the perfume.
Well, as it stands right now, Marie.
What do you have against me?
You have 2 hours in the studio tomorrow. Did we call Ariola? Is she in for tomorrow or no? She is? Well, she isn't. I don't know. We'll find somebody. Trust me.
How about this bottle of water right here?
2 hours is plenty of time. Marie?
Yes, sir.
2 hours is quite the lengthy bit of time for you to be a co-host.
Oh, really?
Yes. Yeah. That's
so more than most people can.
So why did you say 4 hours before?
Well, I'll tell you what. Mm-hmm. You'll come in at 6, and yes, we'll play it by ear.
Alrighty then.
That means you'll be done by 6:05.
The T-Man.
All I have in this world is my balls and my word, and I don't break them for no one.
Seattle's number one. Number one.
How about you, Constance? Should they forget about it?
No.
Oh.
Don't forget about it.
You don't discriminate?
Nope.
You like them in all shapes, sizes, colors, mm-hmm, creeds, religions, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Just wear the right shoes.
Yeah, exactly.
With the right pants.
You have to have the right attire.
Yeah.
You're very big on fashion. A man has to be dressed appropriately for you to give him the time of day.
Somewhat.
Mm-hmm.
But don't get me wrong. I like sweats.
We never get you wrong.
Tims and that kind of thing more than I like suits.
Right.
I like casual look.
I see. But it has to be the right...
Not halfway dressed, halfway casual. That's
it has to be
not...
the right casual look and pick a style and go with it. You can't go half cash, half dressed.
Dressed, yes.
The boys in the room look good today?
Yes.
We had a dress.
That's right.
When we go cash, we go cash.
Yeah, when
that's
we go
right.
crap... We go all the way crap.
That's right. No one knows crap better than us. And the more I think about it there, Jimmy Fred Weeman, the more I know that Marie's not going to make it past that second hour post. So you better start booking. Get like H's, get Broke Paula, get who else we have out there? Audrey, the chat line girl. Mm-hmm. Let them each do 15 minutes for all I care. Who else is out there? Dumpy's wife.
We make a decision on
yeah,
gay yet?
Yeah, that'd be cool, Dumpy's wife.
Dumpy's wife.
Yeah.
Day's wife.
Miss Kitka?
Yes. But obviously, it was easy to get through the 4 hours with Constance the bitch
Yay.
There. She has made it a very entertaining for us, not really. And she has to get her money's worth with her 24-hour contract this morning with all the payments she's getting. Why? By reading stories right now. I know you love reading stories.
I know, but I want to do calls.
You don't like stories. You hate stories, don't you?
Kind of.
You trust me.
No, the J-Lo one was interesting. I like talking about stuff like that. But
you don't want to take calls.
I do.
You want to know the reason you don't want to take calls?
Why?
Because the calls bash you. You know that.
That's okay.
Oh, jeez.
At least I'm on their mind.
Yeah, but you got to get to a point where you get tired of the callers bashing you.
I expect it.
Mm-hmm.
Not all of them bash me. Some of them, you know.
The callers bash you because they're jealous?
No.
The callers bash you
because
you're opinionated?
Because
the callers bash you because you're strong-headed?
No,
the callers bash you because you're very stern with your feelings?
Maybe. They don't want to know the truth. They don't want to know
do you
how
a know the
strong
truth?
Woman feels.
If you want to know the truth, there's more truth than I can even give you.
Okay.
I saw you when Tony was leaving the studio, and as much as you bash him, as much as you put him down,
yeah,
as much as you say that he is a loser because he wears casual with dress-ups and because he has not the amount of intellect that you like in a guy, I can guarantee you the way you looked at him walking out of the room, that if he called you tonight and asked you to come over for like a 2 a.m. thingy,
no.
You're there in a heartbeat.
Come on, no.
You're telling
no.
me I'm wrong?
I'm telling you you're dead wrong.
Maybe 10 o'clock at
I
night?
No. And you know what? I respect
9:30.
Him a little. I respect him a little bit more after today, but no way.
What if he calls you? I'll make it easier for you. What if he calls you and says, Constance, let's bury the hatchet. You know there's obviously some passion between the both of us.
No.
Dinner this weekend.
No. I'm busy this weekend. No. No, I would not.
You're truly busy
Trust
this
me.
Weekend? What do you got going on this weekend?
Going
Tell
to
me
Portland
now, quick,
with
quick,
my
quick.
My best friend, going to Portland.
Liar.
Going to the strip clubs in Portland.
Oh, jeez. That's nice.
You can drink jeez. In there, and they get fully.
I've been there,
yeah.
I know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I'm going to the male strip club. So.
You're going to the strip clubs where exotic male dancers will yeah. entertain before you?
Of course.
Leave your kids in the hotel room, or
no? They're going with their dad. They're going with their dad.
Now, would you consider that seedy behavior for a woman to undergo on a weekend that she has very available, since her former husband is taking the kids for the weekend? That
no.
she uses that opportunity to go see male strippers in Portland?
It's my business. Whatever he does on his time, it's his business.
It's your own business
yep.
to do what you want to do. Okay, fine, it's your business, and it's
yep.
no one's business but yours.
Yep.
But if someone else were to go
no.
and see male strippers on the free time that they have, would that be considered seedy in your opinion?
No, I don't care what people do on their free time.
Mm-hmm.
My children are completely taken care of when they're with their father. I don't have to worry about it. I don't, you know, I call, he calls me. We're very in touch with each other. I'm a good mom.
You're on the air. She wants to take calls.
Yes.
Hello?
Hello?
1-866-663-T-MAN. Go ahead.
Hi.
Hello.
I was just calling because when I first heard Constance with the Bitchler and or everything like that, I thought she was in her early 30s and just kind of like an older 30, like and kind of bitter. But now that I heard she's 24, that's just sad that she's so bitter and so bitchy already.
Do you consider yourself a bitter woman, Constance? Do you feel that bitter is a good way to describe you? Is that fair or no?
No. And can I comment? You know what? I respect your opinion.
Oh, jeez.
But I will not sit here and allow men to treat me any kind of way that they want to treat me. It's not bitter. It's I was raised right and I know the truth. My eyes are open. Now, if you women in Seattle want to walk around with your eyes half shut and take it and take it and take it and then whine about it and bitch about it when your man cheats, when your man goes out, when your man's broke, when your man doesn't work, when he has 62 kids,
oh,
that's your business. But I am going places in my life. Yes, I have two children.
You're going to the
strip
clubs.
No. Yes, I have two children. Yes, I'm a mother, but I was raised right. My father raised me very well. And if my dad's treating me that well, where he still opens doors, tells me he loves me, all that kind of stuff, I'll be damned if a man doesn't do the same. So go ahead and take all
face.
The men.
Yeah.
Go ahead and take. I won't settle. You can settle, but I'm not. No. I'm sorry that you think you're going to be here in 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
No
whenever,
bitterness
but.
Here.
But she no. deserves a glory, glory, hallelujah.
I'm not bitter. I'm not bitter. That's the truth.
Right.
Oh, my gosh. It's not even just men, though. I mean, you're just like, mad in general at the world. You don't like women.
No, I'm
you
focused.
Think that every man's going to do you wrong, so you're just going to. Think yeah. about him first.
Yes, there's
and
focus.
It's like you're constantly on guard instead of just letting him get down and enjoying life. There's always someone that has to
Honey.
Prove it to
Is
you
Is that
first.
Fair or not fair?
To a degree, that's fair. But I do enjoy life. I'm not. You guys don't see me my day-to-day life with my children. That's when I enjoy my life. All this stuff about men, that's like fifth place to me. I don't care. I'm going to be all right. My number one priority is my children and God. Now, whether you want to believe that or not, I'm sorry.
How about
this
the caller?
This is one
do you,
aspect of me.
How about the caller? Do you have big boobs?
Do I?
Yeah.
Yes, I do.
Good. Thanks for the call. Now, Constance, yes. when isn't there a time when the truth, as you call it, and bitterness go hand in hand and there could be both? I mean, you talk about how, really? Oh, it's not bitterness, it's the truth. But can it be the truth and... It also is bitterness.
I'm not bitter. I'm not bitter. How as I can't be the best mom I can be and the best woman I can be walking around bitter.
You're out of the air.
Hey, what's up?
Maybe you're not the best woman you could be. Maybe you can be bitter and you just don't know it. You're out of the air. Hi.
Hey, T-Man.
Yes, sir.
I want to know why the hell Constance is on 15 of the dysfunctional family list.
Where should she be?
She needs to be in the top three.
Oh, jeez.
I don't know if that's a compliment or a put down.
No, it's a compliment.
Yeah.
People embrace the dysfunctional family as their own. And if this man says you should be in the top three, this is obviously a big fan of yours.
No, he's just saying I'm more dysfunctional than I let on.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's something to be proud of.
This is one of the most entertaining shows I've ever heard.
Okay. Oh. It was until you joined us. Thanks very much.
Yeah, thanks for screwing the whole thing up.
You're on the air. Hello.
Hello?
Yes.
Hi, T-Man. I have, you know the little thing on the radio station say you have breasts the size of big bologna slices?
Right, that's
oh my
you?
Lord.
All right,
no.
Hang on. Those calls are coming up next segment. You're on the air. Hi.
Don't hang up, please.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Yes, go ahead, sir.
Yes, I just wanted to call and tell Constance that she's great. I love her.
Oh,
I'm married. I got three little girls. And if my girls grew up to be just like her, as strong-minded and strong-willed as she is...
Yeah, bologna slices I'll the next segment. Thanks, sir. You're out of the air. Hi.
You got three girls. You got a good shot.
Yes. The odds are in your favor
right.
there, my
Yay.
Friend, that you'll have deli meats all over the place.
Gross.
You're out of the air. Hi.
Hello.
Yes.
Hi, T-Man.
How are you?
Oh, I'm pretty good. I was just wondering, how could you get a girl... like Constance on your show. She can't even answer one question. I'm 19, and I answered all those questions
sure
right.
Mm-hmm.
Were you yeah. in your car answering them out loud?
No, I'm at work.
Are you serious?
Yes, I'm at work right now.
Well. Honey, I believed you about that, but I'm talking about the questions. Come on now.
No, seriously, I answered them all right, and I'm 19 years old.
Ooh. Well, I'm 24.
You're out of the air. Hi.
Hey, how you doing?
Yes.
I got a question with Constance.
Mm-hmm.
Do you believe that the process of evolution right now has been changed, that women right now F's around harder than guys?
They screw around. They screw around more than guys.
Exactly.
He considers it part of Darwin's theory.
Yeah, women. Oh my. Yes. That's why I have a best friend and then two or three female friends that are close. Because the women.
You don't trust anybody.
They're not. The women. No.
If you have too many women in your life as friends, one of them's going to screw your man, and when you eventually have a man, is that what you're saying?
How come most women right now they try to pretend they're all clean and they don't really do shit?
Okay.
But they do something.
I don't know, honey. All I would suggest to you is don't trust them. Don't trust them.
All right, well, we missed that one.
Kind of.
Right?
It was kind of covered up.
And one more question. Do you mind, T?
Yeah, that's three now, sir. For those keeping score at home. Go ahead, yes.
Charge for everyone, too.
I can understand women right now. When you date them,
it's all the same
when
theme.
You date them, they think that they're giving you a gift. When
right.
you have sex with them, they think they're giving you a favor.
Well, hey, what are you doing for them?
You're sick of going out with women that make it seem like they're doing you a favor? Is that what you're saying, sir?
When you go out with them, it seems like you're doing them a favor.
You would be lucky. You're hoping that the day comes that you actually go out with a woman that is normally with a mindset that she's not out to and doing you this huge favor by having dinner or whatever you're doing on this date.
Uh-huh. That's why
is that too much to ask?
That's why I call women like the cheapest creatures on earth.
Oh, geez. Is that true? Is this man tapped onto something here that needs to be discussed? Do women
maybe.
Feel like they're doing men a favor by accepting a date with them, a
exactly.
dinner invitation?
No, maybe, I mean,
or is it just this guy?
Maybe just this guy, but
no,
I mean, I have seen cases. But see, it's all about beneficial. If they're not benefiting your mind, body, soul, whatever, why are you with them?
Sir,
so
when you ask a girl out, sir,
what are you doing for them?
He wants to get laid. When you ask a girl out, sir,
well.
When you ask a girl out, does she demand a major credit card first?
Of course, she wants to know how big is my wallet.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that would be an escort, and we might want to walk the other direction.
90% of women are like that.
90% of women.
Artist.
You've done a study on this. How old are you, sir?
I'm 24.
You're 24. No. And do you...
Basing through my experience, T.
Say again?
Basing through my experience.
Based through your experience, and you are not shy. You ask a lot of women out. And the dates you go on, every one of them across the board, at least 90%, seem like they're doing you some huge favor by sitting there with you.
Are you attractive?
I believe so.
Well, you might want to work on that if you don't know for sure.
All right, look at yourself in a full-length mirror right now and describe to Constance, because we're men and we don't care, what you look like. Go ahead.
Basically, I'm a gymnast, so that means I can tell that my body's really ripped. And based on my looks, I think I'm okay, and I got an 8 inches personality.
Mm-hmm. So you're a gymnast, and how tall are you there, sir?
5'7".
Nope, that's it. That's it.
Well, what about a guy 5'4"?
No,
that can't be
I mean,
good.
At least I got 8 inches personality.
What is 8 inches personality? You talk like that and you want a woman to really want to go out with you?
That's a crafty way of describing
on.
The size of his male
no.
unit.
Come on.
Yeah.
Sure, exactly. He's a gymnast?
Yes, he is.
Oh, Lord. Maybe not. All right, whatever.
I don't know.
He has eight
I'm
inches of personality,
him.
Constance, and his 5'7" body, he's still a packin'.
Exactly.
That's his opinion.
And
that he
too
has
bad women
personality.
Don't have X-ray vision, because if they did, they wouldn't make it seem like they're doing him a favor.
Well, that's the wrong
to be
type
sitting
of woman.
To be sitting across a table with him. He's not talking about types of women. He's talking about all women.
What
90% of women make it like they're doing you a huge favor.
But generally, men stick with the same category of women. Generally, men stick with the same, you know, they kind of look like this or the same genre of women. Now, if you're of two, don't go for a 22, and they wouldn't act like they're doing you a favor. It's very simple. It's not math. It's very simple. Come on.
No.
Step it up.
Women right now, they're
change
always,
your approach. Talk to different types of women.
You know, 90% of women is like that. It's really hard to find. That's including you.
I'll just.
You know? I heard a while ago you told everybody that you're a bitch. That's why you need to be treated like a bitch.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, okay.
You're out of the air.
You need to be treated.
Hey, Constance.
Yes.
How big are your meat puppets?
Oh, jeez. Jeez.
That's the type of men Seattle's dealing with. You see what I'm saying?
That call came from another state.
That's why I'm single.
You know you want to answer.
What,
yeah, by the way.
Be like, oh, hey.
Since we're on the topic.
On.
Somebody brought it up.
You're out of the air.
Hey, I'm looking for 8 inches of personality.
Oh, man. You want this from Subway, though, I think, is the difference.
Yes.
Feet.
Yeah.
Double made.
Yeah. The T-Man.
You're just another lying old dirty birdie, and I don't think I better be around you for a while.
That's a great story, let me tell you. Your husband knows about that, your ex-husband?
I don't know if he does, but he does now.
Constance was just filling us in on how she threw her her wedding ring upon her divorce underneath the Tacoma Narrows Bridge.
A little bit prior to the divorce.
Glad to know you're not bitter. God. So what kind of knockoff purse is that?
My purse?
Yeah.
It's not a knockoff.
Nowadays, don't be insulted. Every woman wears a knockoff these days. What woman doesn't have a knockoff purse these days? Tell me.
I don't.
Come on.
Whatever.
Even I have a knockoff. Everybody does.
Right. A knockoff purse?
Yes.
What kind of purse is that?
Esprit.
Esprit? Mm-hmm.
Kate Spud.
Kate Spud.
Esprit. It's our final segment. As Constance is helping as co-host. Mm-hmm. It's our final segment on the program today. At least from a live standpoint. Mm-hmm. Constance?
Yes.
You decide how you'd like to spend that time.
I don't know. I don't
okay,
know.
I'm game.
Where do we sign up?
Let's do more okay. callers. Or
you love the calls, don't you?
Let's get
you
personal.
You love
yeah.
the calls.
I do. I want to know.
You don't want to do let's do personal. Let's get personal.
Sure. Right.
Yes.
Yes, I do.
I'm telling you, you don't. Just take regular calls, please. I'm begging you.
Why?
Something tells me it's going to turn into that anyway.
You're on the air. Hello.
Hey, T-Man.
What's up?
Hey, my name's Logan.
How you doing, Logan?
Good. I'm a good buddy of Tony's. And, you know, you would think, you know, good friends are going to take that personal stuff that Constance is saying. I'm not taking it personal. I just need to ask Constance a couple things.
Okay.
One, you're looking for a man, right?
No.
Well, I mean, you're looking for...
Open for one,
man,
yes.
That you're looking for. You want
she's
a good
open
man,
for one. Get the clarification right. She's look. Okay, she's open for one. She's not looking for one.
You got to act like a lady to get men to open up doors.
Ow!
You have to do it automatically.
Hey, why whoa, do you deserve manners, like- whoa!
Why do you deserve to be treated like a lady? And I don't want to be yelling and screaming at you like you do. You take things way too personal and you can't have a logical conversation. But if you want to be treated like that, if you want men to take you out, if you want to find a good man with a good job, you got to be acting like a lady, treating him good.
The man is calling you illogical.
Constance, here's the deal. You are the woman that every like best friend wishes their boyfriend would never date because you seem really nice in person. I've met you in person. You're all right. I mean, you're not ugly, but you're not cute.
Oh, wow. Wait a second. Are you the one that I met? Wait, where did you meet me? Are you the one that
hold
I
up,
met
Constance,
when you were with
up,
those
hold
two
up.
Girls?
This ain't Jenny Jones. We're not going to get
who are you? What do you mean, hold up? Hang up. What do you mean, hold up? You hang up.
You sure you want to take calls?
Yeah, I am. But who cares? first of all, when I am with a man, I treat him very well. I'll be the first to come out of my pockets. I'll be the first to buy him presents. And No, because I don't play. I don't put up with anything.
No guy's going to stand around
no,
for
I'll
that.
No, I'll walk away or
well,
I'll
don't piss
up.
Her off.
Don't mess up. You know what I mean? I'm not going to stand in your face and yell at you and treat you like a child.
Constance.
You don't know me, honey. You know what Tony has
you know
played
what?
For you
you're
over his little
person.
Recorder.
Constance,
so.
You're not a, listen, let me just say this. You're not an ugly person, but your attitude, personality, your mouth, your overall presence, it makes you very ugly.
Thank you.
It makes you very ugly.
Santa
thank
Cruz, you. Hello.
Hello?
Yes. Who's
T-Man.
This? Who's this?
This is Kelly,
you're in Santa Cruz?
Yes.
What can we do for you, love?
I just wanted to first of all tell you that I absolutely love your show.
Gouges.
And we needed you down here.
Right.
And also, I was wondering, how did the dysfunctional family members become dysfunctional family members?
Hold a second, just tell by the tone of your voice, you're off to a good start. over the course of time with calls that you make, we'll just have a determination as to whether you are one who fits the bill of dysfunctionality. And we will start taking motions as to whether you should be placed into the dysfunctional family. But we don't know you from a hole in the wall yet. We don't know you from Job. And we're going to take some time, obviously, over the course of months to figure out who you really are deep inside.
Oh.
We know Constance through and through by now. We know
Constance,
she fits the bill.
Don't worry about what everyone says. You go, girl.
Oh.
You know you, and that's all that matters.
Right.
Can that phrase go as well, please?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Didn't we leave you go, girl, in the 90s?
I wish we would have. Sounds like we didn't, though.
All right.
Jeez.
We threw it out in the 90s trash with kick you to the curb.
Right. Talk to the hand.
Talk to the hand. Then sayings jeez. Like that, all right? Now, if Santa Cruz didn't get that memo, we could resend
yeah,
it.
Yeah, maybe they're... We need to help him out a little bit.
Wow. You're on the air.
Hello.
Yes, time is short and so am I. Go ahead.
How's it going, T-Man?
All right.
My name's Mike, and I was looking to ask Constance about
needing a real man.
She's like yawning and stretching.
It's not. She doesn't need these guys to.
And this real man that you speak of, do you know anywhere where he may exist, sir?
No, he's down somewhere.
Right.
And but she doesn't need to deal with all these guys who have to brag about their 7 inches of personality.
Wow, he just got cut down 1 inch.
Sure did.
Yeah, he did.
Well, down south, it loses some in the translation. Yeah, okay, so you're obviously talking about yourself there, sir, huh? Well, I'll tell you what, the celebrity listener star dating is obviously going to continue over the next couple. Have we set up the next star date, by the way? I think it's time to do that. And Constance is available, by the way, as one of the dysfunctional family members. She could show up across a table from a guy in the listening audience. Yes, sir, have you sent in your application to be one of the listeners... to be set up with a star date?
No, I haven't.
Well, you better get cracking.
Well, we're
now, of course, you could be selected and then have the opportunity to sit across a dinner table from a Constance or maybe a Broke Paula. It depends on what stroke of luck, what force of act of God or force of nature is working in your favor.
Mm-hmm. Is Starr in the deal, too?
Maybe if it's your fate, it'll be Broke Paula.
What did he say?
Star is yes. Star is... Constance hates...
Do you
hates
listen to the program, honey?
Wow.
Come on! This is not two for one.
Well, honestly, I think it's time for you to start to accept that the guys that are into you in the listening audience...
No, they're not into
also,
Star, you know.
Also have a serious attraction to Star.
We can't get on more opposite ends of the spectrum.
Well, apparently you're closer than you obviously perceive yourself to be, because guys...
No, we're just
guys,
both bitchy, or we're just both outspoken. And
guys
like
who are
that.
Into Star are into you as well. You must have a lot of common threads. You must be like the same person.
I'd rather die.
Oh, jeez.
Ooh, wow.
You'd rather die than find out you have similarities to Star?
I do not have similarities with her.
But what
at
if you found out if they did some biological analysis of you and they determined that your chemical makeup is very similar to Star's? What would you do?
Take some altering drugs or something. I couldn't.
I'd do that anyway.
I really don't know Star, but what I do know is she needs to take her mouth off her mom's titty.
Oh, geez.
Because I would never be like that ever. I would never allow. No. No.
You're on the air. Jeez.
Hello?
Yes.
It's finally me.
Yes, it's okay. You.
Okay, I just want to say I agree with Constance because I think so many women these days just let guys walk all over them.
Yeah.
And then they bitch in the end, but they let it go on the whole time.
Yeah.
I love the end.
And guys are used to these pushover women who let anything happen, and so then when there's someone who's going to stick up for herself, they have a problem
They're
with it.
They're a bitch. Right.
So I go for the end right at the
okay.
beginning.
Okay. T-Man, and I also want to say I totally love your show, and this is actually the second time I've called and held for a half an hour. Last time I held for half an hour, and I didn't even get through.
Well, you made it up.
Because the show ended.
Right.
But, yeah, you're awesome, and I love radio broadcasting, and that's
okay, thanks for the call.
That makes one of us, right?
Yeah. I love radio broadcasting.
Right. Big fan.
I took so many classes.
Right.
It really paid off.
Look, we're not giving you an internship. Stop calling.
Endless amount of classes.
Right. The headphones go here.
Trust me, if you ever want to make it in radio, the last thing you want to do is take a radio class.
Yeah.
All right, Constance?
Okay.
Just
be dysfunctional.
Constance, you did a stellar job filling
Thank
in for
you.
Cherry Free on our honeymoon this morning.
Thank you.
Now, tomorrow morning, we start with Marie. Where we end? Lord only knows.
The T-Man.
I mean, not many girls in contemporary American society today would give their underwear to help a geek like me.
Star said that she realizes now that maybe it was a sign from the Lord that you need this a lot more than she does.
Oh, okay. That's why she's a loser.
Wow. I'm such a loser, you know, with my
That's why you're up there hating. Stop hating, okay? Stop hating. Star, I have a few rejects up here. I'm
That's okay, because she ain't taking the time to get to know them. Maybe they are good men. She can get stuck with a loser herself.
I don't have time to get to know them. I don't care. I mean, I can tell right away if I want to date them or not.
Well,
you can take some time to get to know them.
Well.
So I'm sending them your way.
Oh,
then you can take
all
the time.
No, that's okay. That's quite all right, because I can do well on my own.
Obviously not.
Like I said, you probably need this, you know, with your 20-year-old,
two kids. See, you asked one question. I'm sorry?
I'm sorry. What?
What did she just say about my kids?
Uh-oh. I said you got two kids and you're 23.
That's right. I was married, sweetheart, for 3.5 years, okay?
That's great.
Close your mouth.
Because now you're divorced.
Stop speaking about
it. Save the mom blow.
Don't hate me because I'm just getting started with my life. And I got a whole long road ahead of me.
Okay. How about Star saying she couldn't make a marriage work already?
I know.
Hello. Not able to make a marriage work. Hello.
At least I know I'm going to be making good decisions for myself.
Wow.
I got my life ahead of me.
By having sex with basketball players.
It's baseball, first of all, and then I get a relationship.
That's better. And that's why they hit and quit.
Get it right. You don't know me. Get it right. You don't know me.
Hit and quit. Blow.
How about you ask everybody, 23 years old, have two kids already, and 20 years old.
You think you're such a quality chick,
huh? You know your mom's not talking junk.
Oh, shut up. Right. You wish you were me.
Look what she raised. Look who your mom raised. She's not going to
tell me. What about a mom? What about me?
Are you talking about my mom? You get up here. I'll show you what a bitch is.
Your mom's lazy. You're that way, home. Oh, she's fat.
She's fat? Yeah, that's what I thought. Tell me to gain weight. Look at yourself. You let yourself go.
The T-Man.
Here's to 5 miserable months on the wagon and all the irreparable harm that it's caused me.